was always something that I've done. But I don't wanna live that way. Even to every word you say. You said that you could let it go, and I wouldn't get you hung up on somebody that you used to know.
You didn't have to cut me off. Because I can never have to know we were nothing. I don't even need your love. You treat me like a stranger, and I feel so rough. Oh, I didn't have to stop so long. Have your friends collect your tickets and change your number. I said I don't need that girl. Now you're just somebody that I used to know.
Somebody. Greetings and good evenings to all of you. Sorry about that recent mistake there. Showing Cyrex's penis on a live stream. Without a preface, like Cyrex's fungal penis or something scientific, I feel that it's subject to strikes. However, the fungal penis page cannot be struck because it is such a horrifying and horrendous looking monstrosity and abomination even. So I don't think that'll ever get taken down, but as I'm sure you're all aware, there's been trouble in paradise between Cyrex and Tange, and it seems that they are no longer together. I'm sure all of you are heartbroken about this. As am I. You know, it's definitely a storybook romance, one for the ages. Tangerine Cat.
Hello.
Good evening to you.
Good evening.
How are you tonight? I guess the million-dollar question is, what happened?
Well, I've been unceremoniously dumped without a message or a phone call, anything really, and I just found out through a Discord message, and I went in to send a message to Cyrex, and he blocked me, dumped, finished, kaput.
What's led up to this?
Well, for the fourth time, he's apparently he's accusing me of working with you. For the fourth time.
Well. It seems that he just doesn't have a whole lot of trust in you.
Obviously not. He's accused me, and I think that, you know, when you're accused so many times, sometimes you just might as well just do it.
Yeah, yeah. If you're in the doghouse, you might as well do what you're being accused of. I would say that's probably fair. Was there anything that led up to this?
Well, I think personally it's because he felt like he was going to get caught out cheating, because I had some messages sent to me again. Wow. So, and I said I was going to investigate it. So I think that that might have pushed him to do this. He says it's because he feels like I've sent information to you guys, but.
Yeah, I mean, I've always said, and as Cyrex knows, that how I obtain my information. You know, why would I even need to speak with you or interact with you for information when I already have everything that goes in, goes out, comes in, you know? That's pretty much that, but...
Well... I mean, I know that you'll be a good shoulder to cry on. He's driven me into your arms, and here I am.
Oh, wow. Wow. Can I ask, like, whatever interested you about Cyrex?
Well, it's interesting looking, it's different, and that caught my eye. And I also thought that he was a successful author, that he'd actually had a book published, but I've since found out, I've got him to admit that that is untrue. There's been.
The soul census.
That's right, yeah. He admitted that that was, for a better word, want of a better word, bullshit. He made that up, which we all knew because he even spelt the title incorrectly. I'm feeling very bitter that I've been dumped, so I think I'm going to be quite happy to answer any questions tonight. It's been a public relationship. Let's make it a public breakup. Let's go.
Very interesting. I'm going to post the StreamYard link in the chat and see if we can field any questions.
Well, yeah, I've seen that there's been a few theories about my intentions, my mental capacity for actually entering a relationship. So I'd be happy to answer.
You think that those questions are unfair?
No, I like a good debate. Everyone's welcome to challenge. I don't mind at all.
Yeah, because I know there's been a lot of tangerine haters along the way.
There has been some haters. People thinking that I'm a rape sympathizer, especially after Billy, but they forgot I was the person who actually got Cyrax to talk about this. And I also shared.
Well, okay, all right, here's the first guest. I'm not sure if you're aware of him. He is a juggalo by the name of Madness. I mean, I'm gonna allow him to ask any pertinent questions of the relationship. Madness, do you have any questions for Cyrax's ex-girlfriend?
Not really. I have. Is this his ex-girlfriend?
It is.
Well, how you doing? I talk to him here and there, and Marty, he tells me he's ready to kill himself over your streams.
No, he's not going to do that. Well, he threatens to kill me all the time.
No, he threatens to kill himself.
Yeah, he does it all the time. It's a, you know,
I
you know.
feel really bad for him, Marty. Is he putting me on? What are you telling me?
It's an emotional manipulation tactic. He's better an hour later after his grandma buys him a new toy. It's true. It's true.
You're so brutal.
It's true. No, these are fucking facts. Ask Tangerine. She will tell you herself.
Yeah, every time something seems to go wrong, it's a classic manipulation
I
tactic.
think he's gonna kill himself, you guys. I'm not kidding, and I'm really worried about that guy.
No, his ego.
No, don't be ridiculous.
No, he tells me he's crying. I talked to him on Messenger. It's true.
Oh, madness. You're being ridiculous.
No, I'm not, because I want to help the guy out. I'm going to do a track with him, Marty. You probably are going to own it, aren't you? Do you own him or
Yeah,
somebody like that?
all right. Any he's not gonna kill himself. Do you have any further questions?
Dude, he calls
You
me.
wanna make a bet on it?
I don't want to make no bets. I don't know, man. Maybe he might, dude. I
Listen,
might lose it.
I'll bet on him living.
guy.
Dude, he cries.
Well,
Marty, he cries.
can you not hear me?
I can hear you.
But
I'm sorry. I'll shut
I'm
my
just
mouth.
so, no, it's just that I know this guy so well now, and there's no way that he'd do anything stupid to himself. He's done, I mean, I'd say over 15 times he's threatened to kill himself.
He's been doing the same song and dance for 15 years. Publicly, at least. And
Jesus, Marty,
as soon as you
he's blaming it
let
on you.
me ask you this. Let me ask you this. Next time you see him crying, make sure that you ask him to see his tears, because as soon as you have to see his tears, it turns into, "Why don't you go fuck yourself?"
Yeah, it's a dry cry.
Yeah, always a dry cry.
I don't ever really attack Cyrax. I don't feel I need to have to do it, but I understand, Marty. I do understand that he asked you for Jamie's news and that you have been on a rampage since, and I can agree.
And constantly accuses me of murdering her.
Yeah, I know. Well, I told him, if you keep fucking throwing gas or gasoline on the fire with Marty, it's never going to happen.
Well, there you go. This is like Tange's nightmare. But thank you very much, Mr. Schmeckelcat. How are you, sir?
I'm doing pretty good. How's it going today? Unfortunately,
wonderful.
Tangerine Cat, if you were to ever have a child, would you be willing to still name it Rupel Marx?
I would rather name it dog shit than that.
Well, let's say congratulations for seeing the light, Tangerine. You know, I don't know. The guy's just a rabble rouser. I don't believe he deserves a woman as good as yourself, to be honest.
Clearly not. I'm a cut above. Well, more than a cut. He was lucky to have me for that 3 months. He'll look back fondly on those memories.
Oh, wow. I'm surprised it lasted that long, but, you know, more props for you for tolerating and putting up with and, you know, actually trying to do something good for the goblin, but the wool has been pulling from your eyes, and I'm very grateful for that.
I feel like I need, like, a prize, a gift or something for going this long.
Oh, yeah, okay, I see what you're saying, yeah.
If some saw,
well, that's kind of a weird way of looking at a relationship. I almost feel like you were using him either for his money or as a scheme of making money.
Are you a clout chaser?
Yeah,
I was a clout chaser. That is correct. I thought, look, he's got this growing channel. I might get to, you know, wheedle my way in there and make something of myself. Unfortunately, it didn't work out.
Maybe like start be like one of those Akron housewives, like they have the Atlanta housewives, you know?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's correct. Yeah.
Fair enough. I mean, I think that's why Ed is with Sally. I mean, I assume she's just got to have some big fortune when she dies, or something, or just Ed's just a bum and needs a place to stay with a goblin and a 69-year-old woman. Either way, Tans is good to. I don't know. It's good that you're seen away.
Instead of champagne and caviar, we've got sludge and hot pockets.
Hmm. Well, that would be your daily intake if you were with Cyrex.
It'd be all the major food groups, correct?
Your breakfast in bed.
Yeah. I get a hot pocket thrown on the floor. Go on, go get that.
So on Cyrex News, as some of you may know, excuse me, he has quit YouTube again. How long before he comes back to YouTube? The over and under is noon tomorrow. What do you think the over and under is on that, Marty? Noon tomorrow. Will he be back before, or will he hold out and be back after?
I think he might even come on the stream in a little bit. Some things have been revealed. So I would say definitely under then.
So how did this all happen, Tans? You said you just saw more proof of him cheating and just got sick with it. I kind of missed it.
Yeah, either that or hang on 1 second. You know, because sure. I really hate to make everyone who actually believe this feel like a real moron. Yeah. You know, you know, like it seemed people got so invested in this and actually bought into. This being a real thing. Did you people not buy when she's talking about her raping brother raping her midget brother? You know, like,
Her brother's name was Tiny Tim, for God's sakes.
That's right. And he stuck a pencil
up his ass. Tiny fucking Tim.
He stuck a pencil up his bum as revenge.
Yeah, come on.
But I've literally had like 30 people and always ask, is Tange real? Yeah, of course. She's a human being. Yeah. She's real.
It kind of went downhill when I unfortunately let the camera on when I looked like utter shit. And everybody forgot about the Great Dane raping the midget down.
Not everybody, Tange. Not everybody.
I'll never forget it.
That was one of the greatest stories I've ever heard. You have some kid saying he gets raped by a blind person, and then you got somebody saying their midget brother took a sharpened piece of wood and stuck it up a dog's ass for revenge on raping him.
Yeah.
And the dog was just staggering about.
Yeah, and I mean, Tange, what a thoughtful move by encouraging Sardax to come forward and tell his Me Too story.
Oh, that was great.
Yeah.
And then to have Billy expose him was just even better.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Billy crawling around the floor. Next thing he knows, he's got a little surprise.
Yeah. Not a pleasant one either. Do you think Sardax will ever trust anyone again?
Not now. Look.
I'd say he'd be pretty quick too. I mean, you know, fool me once, shame on me. Fool me 365 times, you know. I feel he'll be in another relationship by April.
Yeah.
I mean, he jumped them pretty quick. I mean, how long was it before Caitlin broke up with him that he was with Tangerine here? Like, not long.
I do think he's got someone else already, actually. I don't think he would have been so quick to block me if there wasn't someone else in the picture.
Martina?
Well, I think he'll have a nasty shock. There'll be two penises in that relationship then. I don't know.
Maybe you should just like find a local woman instead of these YouTube fats. No offense.
Yeah, well, I mean, who are you calling a YouTube fat?
I said no offense. I just said no offense.
Yeah.
Could you just call me a thought then?
Oh, my God. Oh, she's very quick on the update, too. No wonder Cyrus didn't keep you. Never mind. I'm sorry, JK. should we call RuPaul? Ask him how Dad just broke up with the love of my life.
Well, I'll tell you this. He did delete his Facebook.
Did he?
Yeah.
I guess he didn't like the messages.
I'm sure there was an influx.
I saw IP2. I heard they called my dad. Well, clearly he didn't see last night's stream. I heard IP2 called my dad. Now Marty's teaming up with him.
Yeah, Black Cat Whiteface asked, what was Cyrax's daily schedule?
He would stay up all night.
Does he even have a schedule?
He's whatever. Mm-hmm. He'd stay up all night and maybe go to bed around 10 a.m., sleep for about 4 hours and start it all again. When I say start it all again, I mean, you know, doing what he loves, making a living, doing what he loves. Racing.
Eat, drink coffee, rage, repeat.
Exactly, yeah. Coffee, rage,
repeat. It's waste time. That's what Cyrax seems to love to do, is just waste fucking time.
What's this tangerine cat? Does this mean Rax isn't getting his dream racing rig in studio? The racing rig is going spare. In fact, Bloodshot Racing is, I think, Marty, did you say you're thinking of setting up?
Yeah, definitely. It's a new enterprise that we look forward to conquering.
I feel like now I've got this spare money that I didn't, thank God, invest in Cyrax.
If you have phone sex, I don't know if that's a question you want to answer there, Taj.
Yeah, phone sex. No, I wouldn't. I'm a very traditional girl. I don't believe in sex before marriage. That said, he did ask me to marry him. So,
Taj, you need to hop off the stream. Sally needs to talk to you. That's a comment in the chat. That's just a comment in the chat I was reading there. That was a funny one.
Wait a second. So Joss just asked, when did Tange know the relationship wasn't going to work? I mean, I'm not sure if you've been following, and no offense if you've just tuned in, but this may have not have been a legitimate relationship at all. That's just something to consider.
Could have been a ruse.
It may or may not.
Yeah, I don't think Tange had any interest in moving into the Wilkins household.
You mean Tange didn't want to get summer minge from the bedbug lights?
Yeah.
I didn't want a diet of Hot Pockets and coffee?
Possibly Warner has. If I had to go there, I would have probably had a hazmat suit on or a few rat traps with me.
Maybe a hazmat suit, yeah.
Yeah, maybe get someone in to fix the walls.
So I wonder if he's going to sue you as well for having him cause the holes in the wall.
Well, do you know what? I did advise.
Oh,
I, some excellent advice the other day and told, I explained, you know, what pro bono meant, what, how to get legal aid, that he wasn't going to get it because, it, you know, it's not a case that would win anything, and he still won't listen. So if he wants to try and sue me.
I don't know who asked it. It went by kind of quick. Has Chance or Sally ever asked you for money?
Well, yeah, for a racing rig.
I think they meant flat out, like, hey, I need $20. Can you, you know?
No, but I do have an interesting story regarding an amount of money, and I'll let Marty start it.
Oh, shit. Yeah, let me pull up the screenshot here.
Andrew C. asks, did Ed punch Rex? Yes, he did.
Cyrax went running downstairs in a rage because of a stream, because of one of our streams, and went running downstairs screaming, carrying on, and, you know, probably flailing his arms about, and Ed had to just shock him and knock him out, you know, try and knock him out. But afterwards, he was fine, you know.
Yes, no, they are. Someone already asked that. Well, Chance, no, she's not going to buy a studio for Chance. I think she already answered that one.
Yeah, that came a while ago because if you all remember, I did have a drive down there, but I had to turn around because screenshots of him cheating with Martina.
He's going to go live. I bet my bank account on it. Well, I will take that bet. I will take that bet. Let's see here. I'm just trying to see if there's any good, interesting questions here in the chat.
I thought there'd be quite a few interesting ones because I have seen various theories and
opinions. Oh, wait, I mean, I'm on panel here. Let me dig into the vault here. Like, I've been sitting, well, never mind. I don't have really too much to ask you, but
okay, so here's a screenshot between them of Cyrax showing his great math skills. So I figured I'd sell all 38 CDs for $10 a piece and all 15 digital art pieces for $20 a piece. So he should be walking away with $8,300.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was hilarious when I heard about that.
Yeah. Yeah.
The math is more like 600 and some dollars.
You know, this just goes to show that he has no idea of how finances work or math even.
Are we laying it all out there, Marty, with like the whole Cyrax and Tanish thing?
Yeah,
I might have a question. Is it true that Sally rings this doorbell and has like this little signal for him to I've noticed that I've heard a doorbell.
Yeah, because she can't get up the stairs. She's got mobility issues.
So she'll ring for him like a little butler monkey.
It's a doorbell. That's exactly what it is, a doorbell. And she rings it and he comes running down for his hot pockets and then scurries back up.
How much do you think he was into you and how much do you think he was into the racing rig?
I think he was into the racing rig in the studio. This is the fourth time he's finished me. Since January.
Wow, really? I know at least once, but four? So what was the final straw? I mean, you said he broke up with you or you broke up with him?
No, the first time he blocked me because to go on a panel with Marty and actually have a conversation, not scream at him. And the second time, it was a similar issue. It was something, you know, he thought I didn't like Jake Monroe, some weirdo on YouTube. And then the third time, he felt like I was coming between him and his family because I was telling him to get a grip. He didn't need to run to his mum every time he needed to make a decision. And then this time he's accused me.
They're asking for the link, Marty.
Oh, sure.
Well, that's what a roller coaster. I mean, props to you for sticking through it, I guess you could say. I'm sure it wasn't easy, but you know, props to you for putting up with it, having to hear him cry and bitch about probably Marty 90% of the time and what Marty's done to him and why Schmeckle Cat and Marty need to fucking die and I'm sure it was a bit tiresome, but you know.
It's been really interesting. I've enjoyed it.
Sure.
Yeah, you had like unprecedented access into his psyche.
Oh man.
You've had total control over him, like getting him to sing the Blink 1488 stream. You know, obviously couldn't have been done.
Yeah, the I will love you when he attempted that, but couldn't do it because of Bill.
Yeah,
I got him to see Kyle.
Yeah.
Oh my god! All right, just go full blown. Not yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
He's a little puppet.
Do you want to talk about the other money issue yet?
Oh yeah, with the Cash App.
That's what I was saying. You said,
Oh, dude. That whole thing. There was never any money missing from Tanger's bank account at any point. So he just had my money. Yeah. We were able to manipulate him into thinking that, you know, that money actually was missing from her account. So he had to send it back so he wouldn't go to prison. Sorry, X, I'd love to hear your thoughts on that.
You know, he was super hesitant. You know, he wanted to keep that money. He was probably thinking at one point in time, you know what? Fuck Tangerine. You know, I'm just going to walk away from this. $500, $600 better.
Yeah, I did record that call. And look, this is my take on it. Marty contacted me and said, oh, fucking hell, you'll never guess what's happened. And I had to call him and beg for it.
Yeah, there was some intense pleading.
There was, because it's I don't think we could have let him keep that money.
Give him the money back. No.
No, it would have left like a real sour taste in my mouth. To be
no.
Honest. Yeah. it, like honestly, if that didn't happen, I probably would have like, you know, I couldn't watch him gloating and be like, hey guys, look what I just bought and Need for Speed or whatever. Like, it would drive me
insane. Imagine if he knew it was your money, he'd get it like transformed in like to quarters or like dollar bills and just like throw it in the air and just like bask in it. I won, motherfucker.
Yeah. I was pretty worried about that.
Villain.
Yeah.
It was Sally actually who, when she was at first, she was, oh yes, give it back. And then when he took, she says, well, how much is it? $645. Well, oh well, hang on a minute then, don't be so wasted to give it back.
All right, greedy bitch.
And she was kind of angry with him as well
for getting the money back.
Mine and Sally's relationship started to sour from that day on.
What were your first thoughts when you, like, the first time you talked to Sally? Like, how did that go about? Was it more of, like, you pushing towards Sally, or was it more the chance wanting you to talk to her?
At first, I had to push. Oh, no, he did want me to speak to her, but she was quite hesitant. She wanted to just DM, but I insisted that we speak. Out of respect, I wanted to, you know, meet his mother, speak to Sally,
yeah, no,
get to know her. And I think we did get to know quite a lot about the family. You remember from the other day?
I don't know. What time is it right now, and what's the time stamp? 12. That may be old. Yeah, never mind. I think that was already answered. I got a Discord question, but it was already answered, so I'm not even going to bother getting into it. Have you ever talked to Ed by chance?
Nah.
No,
I wouldn't talk, I don't think.
No,
it'd be more
even like a hello, hello.
We have heard him say in the background referred to Tanja as his second girlfriend. Yes. In front of Kelly.
Twice.
And the Sally call, I can't tell you like how much preparation went into it.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
Yeah, like we wanted to have every angle covered, you know, like we ranked priorities as far as because we didn't know how long she'd stay on the phone. But yeah, I think Tanj, brilliant job, just a fucking brilliant.
Oh, it was
job.
Awesome, right?
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
There are Tyler did unfortunately invade my privacy, and there are more calls.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. He's a crafty little crafty little guy he is.
Tyler, that was a little scallywag. Yeah.
Mr. Bowell says this was the greatest troll of all time.
It was a nice long running one too. I liked it. It was gone for a while.
Great job, Tang. Bravo. It must have been exhausting.
Yes, it was at times because he doesn't.
Oh man, having to deal with it.
You can't have a conversation with him.
Did you find him basically talking more, or did you have to like carry on the conversation? You know, like was
guys, he? Guys, I don't know how interested you are in this, but he just went live.
Oh no!
I lost it.
Put it on. Okay, you want me to put it on?
Yeah.
All right.
I already lost the over and under, man.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Of course, it's under, dude.
You're right, because they don't want me to worry. So
I'm bad. I'm
not watching it.
Unfortunately, I have to.
Oh shit.
Back.
Well,
don't want to, but I'm under strict.
Okay, here we go.
Don't want to, but I'm under strict orders from my family to continue doing my streams.
And what? Wait, what?
I know what happened. Stop. I know exactly what happened here. So Chance said he was quitting YouTube, right, to spend time with his family. So clearly he went to go spend time with his family, and Sally and Ed were like, you know what? Why don't you just go do those streams? I don't think you should quit, you know? They got sick of him. So they said, you know what? Just go stream, Chance. We'll deal with it. Walk away from us and go stream.
He probably sat in between them on the sofa.
Hang on a second. Oh my god.
He said his family forced him. This is a good one.
So I had told by my family that I'm not allowed to quit. Basically, I'm not allowed to take a break because they don't want me to worry. So
they don't want you around.
No.
Unfortunately, I have to come back. Don't want to, but I'm under strict orders from my family to continue doing my streams and to not let them, you know, stop what I'm doing. But
what the fuck?
You're so fucking brave, Cyrax. You're a hero.
Yeah, I almost want to go to live for him, just because he's probably just getting wind of this. Hang on a second here.
Bye, she asked me if I knew anybody who
could. What the hell's going on here? Wait, one second.
How long before Sally starts calling Tangerine and just begging her to take her son fucking back, her grandson? Please. Please, Tangerine.
She did say that I was going to be the best
I mean, is he just not going to address us?
Yeah, I don't think he knows what's happening. Just like he didn't know yesterday that I was the one who called RuPaul and not IP too.
Yeah, good point.
Can go over to his stream and mention him.
Yeah.
I know you can't anymore, Tanj. I saw you get banned earlier.
Did he ban me? I didn't know.
I believe he did.
Oh well.
I'm not 100% sure on that, but I'm 95.
Well, if I was him, I wouldn't let me back in either.
I'm still alive in the chat, man. I don't think he spotted me yet.
OG, got a little labs, boy. Where I first started, since FL Studios don't want to work, I'm gonna make it work, boy.
You know, there are times like where we've thought that we got something that's really gonna get him. And it just completely bounces right off his back.
You know what, though? I don't think reality's quite hit him yet, though. I believe he will be making an angry stream about this within the day. Sometimes he does do that. And then, like, remember when I asked him about the Zach Hussein, you know, what type of caliber gun he used? It took him, like, fucking 5 hours to realize what I did to come back and get mad at me. I mean, it's going to take him a bit. I don't know. I could be wrong, but I think he'll do an angry stream within the next, you know, day here.
Yeah, I think Carrie Silveri is on a delay here, and I think she's in for a rude awakening.
Mm.
I'm back in the beginning, but I knew Tant wasn't a troll. I really like her.
Oh,
nice. That was sweet.
That's nice, but
I would say the same thing.
We can ask, does Sally really drug Cyrax?
No, apparently not. She's done it once. She gave him a gummy bear, a THC gummy bear, and he freaked out. He absolutely freaked out because he's really against drugs and alcohol.
Do we know about that, Marty?
We do.
Okay. I feel it wasn't the first time, but I do believe it was the first time she alerted him to it.
Well,
I don't believe it was the first time, no.
Well, I don't believe it, but I suggested that she put things in his food, and it did seem to get more and more sort of subdued and a bit. But I asked her 3 times whether she'd done it, and each time she denied it, saying, no, I'm not drugging him. So I don't know.
I mean, he's come on stream pretty sedated, though. I don't know. Just kind of like he was that one day, Marty, you know?
Yeah. Oh, so I guess people are telling right now that Tanger's on the live.
Nice. See if he crashes it.
Let that bitch do whatever she's going to fucking do. I don't care.
Oh, wow.
Aww.
I was a little upset about that.
Ooh.
I don't give a fuck, bro.
He seems unaffected.
Whatever she's gonna fucking do, I don't care.
You know what, guys? I gotta end this stream. I'll talk to you later.
Are there tears in his eyes?
I am gonna have to completely restart this.
Yes! No way. He's gonna cry.
You think he's gonna come over here, or
I think he's about to go cry. That's what I think. I mean, why is he gonna restart it? It's running just fine.
Has someone asked him to come over? Can he like?
Yeah, people.
Let's restart here.
I gotta restart. It
won't take long, but I'm gonna hang out here, talk to you guys about my brand new upcoming album that I'm dropping soon.
Oh, he's restarting a game. I thought he was starting a stream.
Yeah.
Don't worry, man.
That's unfortunate.
Oh, don't worry, man. Don't worry, bro. Like, I'll eventually find that right person.
Yeah. I'm sure.
Can I say this? I think Caitlin would have been perfect for him, you know?
I agree.
Perfect.
I mean, aside from her being slow and her family hating Cyrax, it was a great, perfect relationship.
Well, I think the IQ level was about right, you know, for both. Slightly higher, but he likes to be the intelligent one.
I think that Caitlin was actually significantly smarter than him because she read The Art of War and taught it to him. I guess he didn't really understand it, but.
I mean, I'd rather have a conversation with her.
Yeah, I'd rather not, but everyone's entitled to their wants and desires.
I'll find that special someone, man. Don't worry. It might not be for a while, but...
Yeah, because you're shattered. You're fucking broken.
I'll find that person eventually. Don't worry.
You know, Sally's terrified. She said to me she's terrified of him being... You know, if she passes away of him being left alone, she said someone might take him in, but she think he's going to be left homeless.
I mean, that's fair of her to think.
And she thought I was his ticket out of that situation.
Yeah, it definitely seemed like she was wanting something as well. And possibly even just getting him off of her hands.
Yeah, was she not pushing for him to, like, move in with you?
She did say that she would like him out of the house so her and Ed can have some private time. you know, he's 15.
Private time, yeah.
Yeah, well, Cyrax, I asked him about when Sally said, don't come up, we're having a nap. And I said, is that code for her and Ed, you know, getting it on? And he said, oh, yeah, I've got to listen to that.
What?
Yes.
I got to listen to that.
And he says, oh, I just turn my TV up a little bit. But yeah, I have to, I hear it all the time.
Oh, man.
That would mortify me. Absolutely.
Yeah, it sounds like pretty traumatic even.
I mean, it's good to know that 69-year-old women still want, you know, some dick. But, I mean, at what cost? The grass in the room and...
Well, I don't know if Tanger will agree, because I guess like she's had more interaction with him than a lot of people in a long while, at least anybody who wasn't actually interested in him, which, you know, I definitely think takes a lot of...
Not many of them, yeah.
Yeah, like a lot of sacrifice, and, you know, none of this would be possible without Tange. It took a lot of like prodding, you know, I guess. And I mean, I know I'm thankful because this has been just an incredible saga. But yeah, I think like she basically uses Ed as like a security guard and a bouncer.
Yeah.
He's the muscle of the house.
That's what I was gonna say. Yeah, he's like the bodyguard. He's the barrier.
She is frightened of him. She said because apart from, I mean, we did message quite a lot. I did speak to Sally a few times, and she has admitted a couple of times that she's absolutely terrified of him when he gets into those rages.
Now that this is over, would you be willing to release Sally's Discord number? Discord number.
Yeah.
We'd love to send her some pics.
Well, doesn't she have to accept you first?
She does.
Is she on one of them type of deals?
I think so.
Oh, that's disheartening.
I think a certain person did try to get in contact with her, and she freaked out.
Yeah.
She did not accept.
No.
Even though I did try to persuade her. So, you know, just chat, see what happens.
The one and only that pulled up on Cyrex. Yeah. I guess so, French Dose.
I shot Zach Zane.
But I swear it wasn't self-defense.
Silly does have a Discord. Yeah, I can put it out there. I guess there's really no harm in it.
Is it this? She's got a new one now.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Have you got it?
I do not. I'm sure her thing blowing up will definitely hopefully get Cyrex to come over here. But alone, you know.
We got a question from Ricky who says, "What broke the act?" Oh wait, no, that was that Ricky. What broke the act? There's no way that Cyrex figured this out or actually figured this out.
I think someone that may have helped him. However, the way that he's gone about just cutting me off, it has made me quite. This is why I'm doing this. This is revenge, Cyrax. Don't mess with me.
Oh.
Game on, bitch.
What were like the most sickening moments for you?
Most cringe, maybe?
Either or.
The most sickening is when I saw that picture of their dog. I'm absolutely furious about that.
I thought you were going to say the penis.
Hmm.
Yeah, well, the dog was pretty pretty messed. Yeah, when Tyler showed that, yeah, it was kind of fucked.
Yeah, it was.
Pretty sad.
One of the real consolation there, like for me anyway, is these people really don't know how to look after themselves, so it's not like they're
yeah.
Like to them, they think they're doing the dog just fine, but you know, if Cyrex wasn't covered in bed bug bites, you know, it would be worse to me. But it's still terrible.
I mean, it distracts them from the dog, so that makes me feel better.
True. Did Tange have to take the big goblin cock?
Did he send you jerk off pics all day?
No, I told him from the very beginning I didn't want any of that, and strictly not to send me anything. Like that, and he was the excuse, you know, you get trolled all the time with, you know, people asking for these pictures, and he willingly gives them out. I think it must have been about 6 or 7 girls that I knew of, or pretend girls that I knew of, that he'd been sending. He can't help himself.
Jay Alexander asks, Tange, what did he say about his peen? What's up, Forever Conscious?
He said he got a fungal infection from going in the bath 4 times a day, and
what? We all know damn motherfucking well this man did not go in the bathroom, let alone the bath 4 times a goddamn day.
No, he used to go and soak in the bath because of his scabs, you know.
It's fucked.
But what he was doing was he was like soaking in his own filth, and I think that. Now, I do think it was a bit, we did find out it was a bed bug bite.
Yeah, and Tans was the one who actually discovered the condition.
So John Heyman asks, what is his favorite Hot Pocket?
I don't know.
Probably anyone that's cooked for him, John Heyman. Anyone that's prepared for him, probably. You don't give a fuck the flavor, you know.
Sorry, I don't know his mum. Sally says that he eats like a bird. He hardly eats anything. And when he's stressed, he stops eating altogether.
The breakup of the century.
Yeah, so what you're saying was, like, you know, I guess when I've been bothering him or things have been agitating him, he just starved himself.
Yeah. He just lives in the sludge.
Yeah, I'm kind of curious to see where his head's at.
That's where he confirmed he has bed bugs, yes.
Over there, right quick.
Hang
on. Wait, what?
Let me pop over there right quick and see something.
Okay, let me post the streamer link.
He's only popping and see something right quick. Hold up.
I saw something. Okay, sorry, I got distracted there.
I think I need to have the conversation with him. I hope he doesn't just shower.
Wow.
Oh wow!
Just the fact that she's even on there, it's honestly astonishing, bro.
Why don't you?
Yeah, he just doesn't get it still.
Well, yeah, he still thinks it's real. People have been posting it in the chat here.
Somebody's got to go over there and get him. I mean, I don't know if anyone can get a hold.
Yeah,
of
maybe this needs to be worked out or confronted.
We need closure. Tell him I won't. Yeah.
DG Allen says a new wow.
I'm not even mad. I'm just laughing my ass off how stupid.
Yeah, you look like you're really just grinning ear to ear.
Stupid that is, bro. Like, why the fuck you didn't sit there and talk shit on somebody who's been there for you, dude?
What?
Be there for me.
Fine.
Yeah.
Was he buying you a racing rig?
It wasn't the cheeky shit. No, he wasn't there for me at all. He offered me. He's dumped me. He didn't tell. Oh, I'm so mad at him. He needs to come over here.
Yeah, damn, dude.
Yeah, like, sensible conversation, like two adults, no screaming.
Yeah, I won't say a word.
Yeah, exactly. Mine neither.
I'll even leave the panel. Like,
I think closure would be good, Cyrex.
Yeah, let's finish this in an adult way. It doesn't have to be.
On that clap, that is
smart. Oh, so he's back in his
mouth. No, guilty, you really are. Like, we all know you're guilty. That's why you're up on Marty streams, because you're guilty as fuck.
Of what?
That's what she's saying, Cyrus.
Right.
Fucking music. And I know you're probably watching this too, Tangerine Marty. You're a fucking lying bitch.
Right.
What's she lying about? The fact that she loved you?
Was she gonna buy you a racing rig?
Or she thought your penis was attractive?
Fucking lying bitch.
He's shaking his sludge at you.
You really are. You're a lying ass snake ass hoe.
From him.
Huh.
I'm not the one who's been messaging several women and showing their penis. Their infected one. Dirty.
Very dirty.
And transsexuals.
Like, we all know you're guilty. That's why you're up on Marty's streams, because you're guilty as fuck.
Correct.
Right.
There's no denying that, you delusional bitch.
All my older siblings, except you.
Yeah, I don't even think that's true.
What did he just say?
Nobody else knew about his older siblings except for you.
No, that's not true. That's
yeah, right. No. I mean, we're goddamn, you know, Cyrex are, what do they call them? Our
sleuths?
Well, we could say that as well, but yeah, I mean, definitely we knew we had, you know, siblings aside from Bill. I mean, come on.
Buddy.
Buddy, yes. Dale. Sally Ann.
We knew with Sally Ann, they said that they were going to send him off to Alaska if Sally died. They said they were going to send him off to Alaska because no one else would have him.
Do you think that, and Schmeichel, I don't know if there's a way to set this up, but that I think RuPaul would probably be more interested in talking to a woman. I don't know.
I mean, we could give him a jingle if Tanger would be up for it. Sure.
Absolutely. What am I going to ask him? What I'm considering having a baby with Chance? And no.
Maybe tell him that, like, you know, your 10-year-old kid loves to curtsy. But no, it's too dark. It's too dark. Christ.
9-year-old?
That should fuck me up, to be honest.
Yeah, that's crazy, dude.
I started crying, didn't I? I got really emotional about it.
Oh, yeah. His whole family just seems to be fucked.
It's just such, like, a dark existence for all of them.
Did you do? You told Martin. So, you're guilty as fuck, bitch. The fuck out of here. And the fact that you're out there doing that just shows how guilty you really are.
There's nothing that.
So you still back in music? And you didn't even have, like, the balls to break up with you.
No. Well, he's admitted several times the reason he gets shouty and screams over everyone is because he knows that he's inferior. He knows that he's no argument against anything, especially with me and you, Marty. I know with you, Schmeckle just tells you to shut the fuck up, doesn't he? But he's absolutely terrified of you, Marty. He knows that he can never win. That's why he actually did the soul census thing. He said he just wanted something that he could show you and say, look, I have been successful at something. So it was actually you. Your benefit.
So he stole some. Oh wow! Let's see if we got RuPaul incoming here, guys. It's off the top of my head, so we'll see. Yep, right number. So that's the right number. So we'll just leave that up for at any point in time. You know, you just give me a RuPaul, and I'll hit that button like this. I'll start ringing him.
You have reached
kind of all right. Long. All right. Well, that's there whenever.
Maybe if somebody told him I was going to dox Dale Lynn, if he doesn't come over here.
Yeah. Do you know, if RuPaul does answer, I know what I'm going to say. I'm going to say that I'm Cyrex's girlfriend. I just wanted to know a little bit more about the family and Connie Jean, and could he just enlighten me?
Do you think he'd be more apt to pick up to a number with the same area code as his?
Of course, of course.
All right, we'll try that then here in a bit. I'll get that set up and, well, yeah, we'll get that set up then. Give him a buzz on the different number here.
And you see, even after finding out he's been hosed, he's still just onto his fucking bullshit music.
You know, inside, you know, though, in
he's terms of... Where's the...
Oh, fuck.
All right, for sure.
You know...
Where were we? You're guilty as fuck, bitch. Oh, here he goes. Tempted.
Yo. You ain't nothing but a guilty bitch.
Cyrex, be a man over here and finish it. What coward you are.
Sure. Hold on. What are you going to do here?
Face your fear, Cyrex.
You're so much of a coward, you just have to block someone. Disgusting. Yeah.
Well,
What a life, you know?
Oh, actually, I thought,
well, fuck off, Cyrax.
This is what his family encourages him to do.
It's how he solves all of his problems and copes, I guess.
He said the obsession with making a living doing something that he loves was started when he was about 14, and a math teacher made a comment about like job satisfaction, making your life where, you know, you get your education and so you'll be able to do things that, you know, do work that you love. And he gets things so twisted in his mind, probably because of the IQ issue, that he just takes little bits of what he's being told and just makes a mess. A bit like the adding up, where he got 360 to make 8,600.
Yeah, I got hits to bang out. Bunch of punk-ass bitches. I ain't about to sit here and be fucking trolled by a little bunch of punk-ass bitches, man.
Well, you have been for, like, the past 3 months.
Right.
Music to make, dude. I got hits to bang out.
Yeah, a lot of money to make, motherfucker.
Yeah, people, I hate to ask this, Tan, people ask me all the time, the calls.
Yeah.
But I don't want to put you on the spot.
Okay.
What do you think we should do with them?
Well, Tyler worked really hard to get them.
Yes, he did.
So, and at this point, because the way he's treated me, we're going to play them.
Okay.
Nice.
And we're going to analyze them. And, you know, a public figure, you see, he's a public figure and he wants to be Eminem. And if people had calls from him, they'd listen to and analyze, wouldn't they? So.
Yeah. I agree. And I know that there are some, like, FBI profilers in the chat.
Yeah, it would be interesting to actually get their opinion. I know that... That they have been quite vocal, so I would love an opportunity to chat with them, meet them.
Yeah, love you to pieces. Did he ever tell you how much money he actually makes on his business endeavors?
Yes, zero.
No, that's not true.
No, that's not true. Within a 10-year period, he made 75 cents.
Oh my god.
Yeah, and I guess, like, he was upset because the record company. Or whatever it was, like, only deals in increments $10 and above, so he was never able to get it.
That's correct. Jay was very sore about that, very salty.
Yeah.
He wanted that 75 cents for the rent.
Yeah, the rent, for sure.
He did say that he had some success selling some of the clothing that, you know, on the, what is it, Teespring, some site like that. And he said, you know, he saved a bit for himself. He helped helped Sally pay the rent, got some equipment for himself. So I said, well, how much did you make? What, $60? Probably won't even that. I don't know.
Yeah, but we know that he's sold 2 CDs. And I think he's sold 2 T-shirts.
Yeah, that's really? Right. It's no sense of the value of money, though. That's I'm not saying that.
Fuck would rock a Cyrex T-shirt?
It just doesn't understand the value of money.
Do you want me to get into the call that you discussed before?
We can do, because I think that shows perfectly his mindset on how he's going to make this all work. You know, his music and everything.
Sure, well, let me
do this.
I'm not exactly sure where I put it. Let me.
That pesky Tyler.
Yeah, his skills are just off the charts.
Yeah, he should be working for the FBI.
But hacker's gonna hack, you know, and he can't help himself.
No.
Okay. Okay, yeah. So here he is, talking about investments.
That's right.
it takes money to make money.
Yeah. Speculate to accumulate.
When you first said that to him, he didn't quite understand, I don't think.
No, he didn't understand those words, so I put it in simpler terms for him.
Over the course of, I guess, like 80 calls, I guess not all of them were with Cyrax and some were with Sally, but how many times do you think you've heard him say, do what?
Or, oh, I hated that so much. His mom does it too, yeah.
Yeah, do what? Yeah.
Like, you'll ask him a question and do what? And then you're not asking him to do anything. I hated that. I hated hearing that.
Yeah. Do what? The annoying thing is when you're trying to have a conversation with him and he won't let you speak. He just goes on and on and on. It's like he feels like he wants to be a motivational speaker. He picks up little bits from these motivational speeches that he hears on YouTube and just spouts them.
Yeah, well, so I guess he ended the stream. Let's see what he closed off on.
Okay. All right. I know, Dolph, you're actually about to head over to StreamYard. Start up the stream on there so you guys can really see.
Oh, fuck off.
StreamYard, y'all.
Oh, look at that ending face. Look at that. Look at that. That's beautiful.
A face. Oh,
I missed it. Shit. Okay, so let's just get into the call then. And I'd say this is one of the more like benign ones as far as like volatility, but it definitely shows like an interesting perspective into his business. That's study.
Exactly what I thought. We've got some interesting ones as far as him going off his head, but this is a good one.
Yeah, yeah. This is like, you know, I wouldn't even call it a tease because what we have is like, you know, but as far as like his money and his business talk, I do think this provides an interesting purview.
Hey, sorry, Charles. I was literally downstairs in the clothes in the laundry when you called. That's why, as soon as I heard that thing, I'm like, oh shit, I know that sound. Like, oh shit.
So, is your mum about? Because she's messaged me saying that asking me if I was able to speak.
Yeah, she's downstairs. Downstairs. Yeah, she's in the living room.
You want
to let her know that you're messaging her?
Yeah, just letting her to answer a Discord on her phone because that's how I rang her yesterday. Is that all right?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, sweetheart. So how are you feeling?
A lot better than last night, I can tell you that. And I actually did find out something I did.
Well, this was the night. Do you remember what this was the night after? Was it after he threw the
acumenus? I think this was after the gummy.
No, I think it was after I didn't turn up, you know, when I was meant to go meet him. I think it was. Or just before. We were talking about, I was trying to get him to get a job. And to try and teach him what the real world's like. And he just... No, he won't have it. Sometimes at the beginning, the calls take sometimes a little while to warm up, but the, you know, middle and end are usually quite good.
Sure.
You two had, and this could have solved a lot of stuff. But as I found out, there's this keyword thing where, you know, people can't say certain words in the chat that you put in there. Guess whose name went in there?
Right, okay. You put Marty's name in
there. Yeah, I didn't know that.
How much of his time talking to you is talking about me?
Oh, I'd say about 75%.
Guess what he did today?
Yeah, that's a conservative estimate.
Oh, the thing until
okay.
Literally today when I was scrolling through trying to figure out, like, you know, what to do. Like,
okay, I think this is a pretty good question. Was this like a social experiment for you?
Yeah, it was actually, and it a very interesting one. It was something that I wanted to see how much I could get through to him, and I know other people have done that. I wanted to find out more about the family dynamics. I think that was the main thing, the family dynamics. And I think we got quite a lot, don't you, Marty, on that?
Oh my God, absolutely. Like, we have a better understanding of him than, yeah, like, to be honest, I really don't know that there was much more that we could really do or get from him.
And I wanted to find out his origins as well, which we did. That was something I always wondered about. So that was the main thing for me.
Did your dad really pass away?
Yes. Well,
yeah.
Maybe a little bit before. Well, yeah, he did. I'll just say that, yeah.
Yeah.
It should have been Rupal. Just saying.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, how am I going to, you know, put an end on this? I came across it. I was like, okay, that's not exactly what I was looking for, but that would definitely help.
I think
that would definitely keep his name out of the conversation.
Well, the thing is, I think you're putting so much weight on him, like, as in, you need to work on yourself. He's not.
I know, and that's something I did take into consideration when I did.
And I think you'll find this a lot here. I don't know if you'll agree with me. He seems to just not even listen, but just wait for his turn to talk.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's really inappropriate answers to the conversation that I'm having with him.
Yeah.
Ultimately, is, you know, obviously I'm eliminating him from conversation for good. That way I can go in and, you know, I can work on myself and not have to worry about, you know, being bothered by him anymore. I can actually sit down and relax and do stuff that I need to do to get myself to where I need to be without the worry of, you know, him popping up every 5 seconds of the day.
I know, but eliminating his name is not going to eliminate him. He'll find a way.
Oh, no, man. It'll take him a while.
Yeah. Well done.
Perfect. I went in there and I did actually put the name in there as well of, like, his new channel. I put that in there as well. So, I mean, like, it'll...
Okay, here's a really... Well, I'm not sure if the question as much as it is a statement. Stu doesn't believe the Great Dane story.
Do you not? What was it? The pencil? Or the fact that the Great Dane took a fancy to my midget brother? What?
Yeah, Stu, just because the breed is called the Great Dane doesn't mean they're always on their best behavior.
No. That's right. Naughty dog.
Yeah. So, I mean, I understand your skepticism, but... That definitely really happened. Like, without a doubt. The brother became, like, a radicalized Muslim.
He had it coming.
Because Muslims hate dogs.
Tiny Tim and his big personality.
Yeah.
One dog rape was one too many.
And I think that's, like, really what kind of, like, endeared you to Sally was that, like, I think the brother made it believable to her.
You did. I told her all about him.
And she's probably thinking, she wants to bang her brother. They're both crazy midgets. I could see the resemblance, though. I mean, I could see the attraction, you know. I get it.
Yeah. But it's weird that Cyrax didn't even seem fazed by that at all.
No, he just took it in his stride.
No.
He had his fingers in the triangle position listening.
Yeah, the power bullet.
Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah, tried telling Tiny Tim the Great Dane story was fake. Yep.
He's traumatized. He wets himself every time he hears a dog bark.
Didn't Sally say that you were brave too for telling the story?
Yeah.
How do you think the dog feels anytime he sees a sharpened pencil?
Now he's the dog. He got old, you know. That's when he got the opportunity to shove the pencil up his ass when he had.
Oh, you have to wait for him to become a senior, geriatric.
He had his arthritic medication and it made him a bit woozy.
He's so small and weak. I get it. I get it.
He was staggering around the garden.
Should have shoved the carrot up his ass.
Yeah. Dross says totally 100% believable dog rape story. Well, it's because it happened.
That Great Dane wasn't so great. I'll have you know, it was a spoiled brat.
I don't think Cyrex responded to the story because he was probably busy thinking about blowing Billy. He was a bit distracted.
Well, we were talking about Billy actually when he realized his penis was poorly. We were having a conversation and he ran off. He just went, oh, 1 minute. Ran downstairs and I thought he was going to get Sally to talk to me for something.
Yeah.
And he came back and said, oh, I've got to go to the ER.
Wait, you were talking about Billy at the time, you said?
Yeah, I was making him describe.
So do you think he was having how do you get people say it? Do you think he was having a wink and, you know, he just tugged too hard and irritated something and then, you know, he had to abruptly go to the hospital? You think he was,
I think he had a stirring down there because I was making him describe exactly what it felt like when Billy, I said, you know, did it hurt? Was it uncomfortable? And I made him describe how he took all his clothes off him.
Yeah. Billy,
you know, I mean, he did come up with a good story. And then all of a sudden, he had to go quickly. He discovered that his penis had become swollen like a egg. Like an egg had been shoved up his urethra.
Yeah, like, here's the thing that I know they do with sex offenders. Like, they make some of them subject themselves to a penile plethysmograph, mm-hmm. which, like, measures the blood flow to the penis when they're aroused. And I think that talking about the incident with Billy caused some blood to flow to it. And
he popped a scab.
Yeah, we actually have the very moment that Cyrax realizes it and runs off in a panic. But I think we'll get to that.
Yeah, it was pretty comical on the Tange's end, I would say.
Tange couldn't believe it.
No, I know. Just her reaction to it, though. It was absolutely gold. The reaction was great. You mean your penis? She's like, you mean your penis? Yeah. She's like, that area, that, you know, I got a bad area. Do you mean your penis? Oh, man, that was great. Yeah. I got to go. I'll call you. How do you? Oh, my God, dude.
Mom. You know, he just calls out to Sally, and like she's panicking. You can hear just tears.
Gotta go to the hospital. Is that okay? No. Yeah, he's fine, but my dick isn't. Look. Oh my God. Do you think he had to present it to her? Do you think he presented it to her? Yeah, showed her?
He showed her and said, "Look."
Oh my God, dude! Holy fuck!
Got back from the hospital. She did say that she would have to apply cream.
I don't even know if I'd show my dad if he wanted. Was like, all right, well, what's going on? You know, I don't even know if I could show my dad. You know, I'd be like, you know, shit, man, we got to go to the hospital. What's going on?
But yeah, Sally was very, very, very hands-on.
Yeah, I believe it. I believe she puts his cream and shit on for him. Like she does his head. Remember the other night she was talking about rubbing the cream on his head?
Yeah.
Yeah, she probably does that with his other head as well.
Yeah.
She does.
Ugh.
Internet.
That's a dysfunction. That family is three words. Dysfunctional. Jesus Christ.
She probably lingers a bit as well while she's rubbing it on, you know, just a little bit too
much. Think she gives it like a whiff to make sure it's just smelling healthy? Just a little. That, does this smell normal to you? What, butthead? Oh yeah, some great Sally in the beginning of his stream today. When the stream called, it's called a family emergency. He had Sally in the beginning say something to him. He goes, "What?" And then she tells him something. And he comes back in. I don't fucking care. Like he was pretty pissed.
Yeah, he was really. It was rude and hurtful, to be honest.
Isn't he always though to her? Remember when he was in the basement? He's like, fuck you.
Yeah, I think right now he's telling Sally, Mom, it was all a game.
A gun chance?
We've been had.
Was it Marty? You already know.
Yeah, what did you do? Who else would kill you?
Marty was pretending to be Tangerine Cat.
They're probably lighting up their pitchforks or their torches. And
right. Angry mob's coming, Marty. Yeah. I told you the other day, man, he's going to show up to your house in the tank when he was talking about being in the military. He's coming to your house in the tank, boy.
Yeah, oh, yeah, that's an image and a half, like with his head poking out of a little hatch.
And then he'd like fucking like just point the rifle towards himself and shoot accidentally, like the big ass barrel. I got something for you, Marty.
Oh, Joss has asked about the subs. I didn't. I think it was Kale.
Yeah. What do you think about Kale?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
You can say that.
Strange guy.
Yeah.
Tangerine, at one point, were you tempted to fake a 10-year prison sentence to get away from Cyrax? For embezzlement?
I told you.
Yeah, Wicked Moon says Charlie probably loves the trolling that has done to Chance. I don't think that's the case, actually.
You know what? I don't think it's the case all the times, but I do believe at some point in time, at one point in her life, she has smiled at it.
Yeah, for sure. That's why nobody likes you.
Yeah, no, that's why nobody likes you. Yeah. Watch your mouth. She said as soon as he hit 18, she's turned into a real asshole.
She's furious about the swearing he does. She hates that.
This is a Christian household. Shut the fuck up. Fucking Sally, Jesus.
Yeah, it's amazing that Sarek is saying that he's not allowed to stream because his family is worried about him. Or he's not allowed to not stream.
Right, his family wants him to not quit. Jesus, he didn't even, like he, I was joking around, man, but I didn't, I didn't think he'd be back like this soon. But who am I? I mean, I should have never doubted it. I thought it might have been a bit different this time, but who am I to ever doubt him?
You know the CD that Kale put in the picture frame for him? I love the fact that he thinks that's an award.
Yeah, the plaque, yeah.
Yeah.
That's incomplicated.
No, it is to him. He claims it as an award. He's said that many of times as well. I've gotten a reward for my music. Never lost a rap battle.
Okay. He had the world record for the longest Chester Bennington scream.
Yeah, he had.
Yeah.
It frightens me, does that? He looks like an alien on that little video where he's screaming.
Well, the thing that I actually hate is he's wearing lipstick and it's even makeup in there, given his dad's fixation. It's not.
No.
I think Lost Innocence was about him telling him to like get dressed up in the dress and get the makeup on. You think that was RuPaul telling him, you know?
I always. Got
some buddies coming over. We're going to run a train on you, Chance. Yeah. I met some boys in the house, you know, in the big house, and we're about to pedal your ass.
Yeah, I don't know, but I was very surprised to see that he was actually somewhat receptive, or at least he said he was, to Chance coming up there and living with him and his brother or something?
Yeah, he said him and his brother own the house.
Hmm.
So, yeah. I believe he got into contact with Sally. I don't believe that Chance called him, but I believe, like, he called Sally or something.
You know, it's amazing, actually, how many other family members that Chance has got. Like, for instance, and I will mention, he's accused me of talking about Daylene, so I will talk about her. Sally says that she never goes around there now. We know that Sally is desperate for grandchildren. She's got loads of them. Daylene's got 4 children, I think. No one ever seems to go around there.
Can you blame them?
Well, no, I can't blame them, but... Like, the extended family that he has, and he has no clue about, like, he doesn't know his sister's surname, for instance. He had trouble. That, and it just seems, to me, that's weird.
Hopefully her sister's wound is just toxified or just dried up. Like, this is the last thing this family needs is more reproduction.
Absolutely, but the, you know, Sally's actual children are a lot older than him, so he has got nieces and nephews. And
yeah, that's true.
You'd think that,
I mean, I would never let my kid near Cyrex. I mean, I would take him, I would scare him straight with him. Like, you know, this is what you don't want to become. Like, this is, you know, look at Uncle Cyrex. Let's use him as like a scare tactic.
Look at Uncle Cyrex.
Look at this guy. You don't want to, you know, look at Uncle Chance here.
Have you ever seen the movie Footloose?
Oh, yeah, of course. Classic.
It's almost like they would outlaw music in their household. You know, and use Chance as like the demon.
I do love that movie, actually.
Yeah, I haven't seen it throughout its entirety, but I do remember the scene where, like, I guess they were having, like, the game of tractor chicken.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
And, yeah, I know eventually he'll find a way around it, but, like, that'll be a while.
Yeah.
I know how it is. That'll definitely be a while, which means that gives us breathing room. So I can get myself back to where I need to be and focus on stuff that we need to focus on, do what we need to do.
I almost think it would be interesting to try to call Sally right now. I don't know if you'd be up for that.
Absolutely.
All right, let's give her a ring.
Oh, that'd be great.
Hang on a minute. What I'm at, right, what is the goal then? And I'll wing it, but I just need to have an idea of what you want out of her.
You should call her crying, saying that Chance broke up with you.
Right?
No, I don't know. I think that'd be funny. Let's just kind of turn the tables.
I'm about to tell her about our son. He's looking at children wearing boys wearing dresses.
Yeah. Yes.
There you go.
Yes. Yeah, I think that's the move.
Let's do this.
What do you want?
What's the law and order?
Oh, hell no.
She's probably not going to pick up, but.
Yeah, 1:40 in the morning, skeptical.
Please. Chance is probably just hounding her like, "This is all a lie, Mom."
Chance, just let me go to bed. No. Ed's got to work in the morning.
Is it ringing?
I can't hear it.
Are you calling Tange, or are you wanting me to call?
No, you'll have to call.
Oh, I'll have to call.
Oh, I was going to say maybe call her on Discord, because then she'd have to accept struggles.
Yeah, you have to ring her. I don't have the cell phone.
No way.
Picks it up.
It's on my other computer.
There's no way that she'll pick up Discord now.
You think she's blocked you? Do you have any communications with her?
Well, I never accept. She got a new Discord, so.
Oh, yeah, you said that's right. You said she's got a new one. That's right.
I thought we had a actual phone number, if you remember.
I think we do, but I don't think she ever picks it up.
Never does, and Chances is always off.
It doesn't. He smashed his phone when.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was down in the basement.
Yeah, I think John Hagen was bothering him, and he just threw it against his bed, and it bounced and just smashed.
He's going back down into the basement. Sally doesn't trust him where there's actual walls.
Yeah, yeah.
That's where you put the shit you don't use, in the basement.
Exactly. But she's going to put some carpeting in there, which will probably get quite soggy, but she's going to try and make it comfortable. Maybe put a dog bed in the corner for her.
soak up this fucking liquid on the floor?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, man. That's where the mouse was running around, too, and then it followed him to the attic. Do you think it'll follow him back down there?
Yeah, oh, absolutely. It'll be in a little, it'll have its little stick and handkerchief with all its belongings in and following.
Yeah, I think it'll be happier back down in the basement.
Well, that's where the goblins belong.
Yeah, he's just smashed so many holes upstairs that, like, he's going to tear the entire thing apart. It's like a war zone.
I mean, it's hard to hit those concrete walls. I mean, I think he could, I don't know what damage he could do down there aside from, like, the block windows are pretty sturdy. So, yeah, I mean, that's a pretty good place to contain him. I mean, if he throws an ocarina against the wall, it's either going to bounce back at him or break, so.
Got me. This is so desperate. You are unfunny hack whose entire life revolves around chance. You're watching it, dickhead.
Right. Well, it seemed to be in your feelings.
Right.
You know, it's 12:45 in the morning here. I don't know where you are, sir, but is there anything else that you're watching right now that people are more interested in?
Yeah, go watch some fucking Married with Children reruns on the goddamn TV or something.
Yeah.
And who's the boss?
Off you fuck.
There you go.
You watch some Taxi. Some fucking late show.
Right.
And just be away from the crap.
The crap?
Yeah, definitely. You need to, there's concerns that you need to sort out.
Yeah, definitely. And I do plan on doing that too. As a matter of fact, today I was actually, it was that video that I sent you. I was watching that earlier today, and I was just like, oh my god, like...
Did you have a look at that Amazon application?
Not yet. Like, I did look into...
Tangent found him pretty much surefire employment. Well, maybe, maybe not, considering his history, but... Yeah, you encourage him to get like a $15 to $18 an hour job, like picking and packing in Amazon.
Yeah, I just did a quick search on Google, jobs in Akron, because Sally had said, oh God, I'd love him to get a job, but every time she mentions it, he flies into a rage. And it hurt. She said it hurts her, genuinely hurts her, because he'll listen to other people before her. So I said, well, I will have a go, and talk to him about it.
Real quick, though, I have a question via Discord. Is there any aspect about Cyrex she was attracted to? Any aspect of him that you were attracted to?
Absolutely not.
It's a negative. Check minus.
There is no redeeming qualities.
There's got to be something. I don't know.
Well, all right. He's passionate. I think we had this discussion, didn't we, Marty, earlier on?
I was making arguments for this to continue. Not jokingly saying that he was passionate. He's very persistent. He's willing to put it all out on the line to chase his dreams. But I guess those are all qualities that could be, you know, he is delusional.
Doesn't have quit in his heart. You know, he goes to kill himself, but instead of killing himself, he jumps on Marty's panel and confronts him. I mean, the guy's got not one bone of quit in his body. You got to appreciate that.
Well, yeah, I mean, after 11 years of trying to make something successful, if he's still carrying on believing the dream, it's pretty impressive.
Yeah, he's like that.
Yeah, like depending on how you look at it.
He's like that guy who sells like the Pet Rock, you know? He's still at it.
Well, the Pet Rock had a lot of commercial success.
Well, that it did.
So, I mean, I couldn't really make that comparison, to be fair.
I genuinely think if he did embrace his weirdness, like he keeps saying about his dark, weird art, if he actually embraced the way that he looked and made that into something that people would want to watch it, because people love watching him go into rages. And there's been a few YouTube channels where they pretended, you know, they're just playing a character, which is what I thought initially when I first found him that he was doing. I didn't think he was real. I thought it was just someone who looked weird playing a retard.
So Renfrew asks, wait, Tanj was also looking. Oh, okay. Tangerine,
yeah, I almost read that one too.
Pyrex 2 on Capital Patrol and being around with Marty streams and talk to Marty behind everything. Like, I don't, no offense here, I don't think you're getting it. I would say that part of the job hunt was a troll.
Yeah, the Amazon were hiring, and I just, you know, I did suggest to him to apply. Okay. I would have actually helped him as well, because like someone said earlier, it's a bit of a social experiment, is this? And there wasn't, it wasn't all me taking the piss. I genuinely did give him good advice.
I mean, what would he do? He couldn't do anything at Amazon. He couldn't lift the boxes. He couldn't operate like a forklift. I mean, he could slap labels on shit, I guess. I mean,
yeah, pick packing, you know, you just, they're all, he could like, do it. He can train like
break down the boxes with his teeth.
Oh, yeah, that'd be effective. Definitely. You just bite through them.
Yeah.
But it was $18 an hour, $15 to $18 an hour. Is that
That's not bad at all, to be honest.
Well, for him, it'd be like being a billionaire if you think he's only at 75 cents in the
last. He'd never make it to his first check.
No, he wouldn't.
You just get mad at somebody, they ask him to do something, or, you know, ask, you know, okay, can you move that? No, fuck you. You move it.
Yeah.
I'm taking a break. You just started. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe if like a factory, I think maybe like a factory job would be good for him. Like someone where he doesn't have to deal with like the public. I think that'd actually be pretty good for him. Like a warehouse job.
It'd make his life. It'd enrich his life definitely because he'd meet real people and find another person who's suited to
start
him.
Earning some money. And you know, I don't know if he'd put it. I feel he'd squander it away for a while, but eventually he might start putting it away. Or he'd probably just earn a paycheck and then buy some shit and then quit and then go back to YouTube.
Yeah, you know,
off of like one check. Yeah,
he'd invest in like some equipment. Be like, all right, now I've got what I need.
Exactly.
Last night a little bit, and went out, but they're looking like full time. And I was thinking about this too, like after you know everything that happened and whatnot and everything. And I was sitting down going through stuff today. Like, something that I really thought about. And it's not that, you know, I'm trying to, you know, get out of stuff. It's something that, like, I legit thought about was that with me being so close to monetization, like, especially with the way things are going.
Yeah, so then he gets, you know, to a position where he can apply for it, and he just deletes his channel.
In such a good direction. What would be the point in, you know, getting a normal job when I would just end up turning around and ultimately quitting the things taking off, you know?
Well,
yeah, but what if they don't take off? Obviously, is the question.
Yeah.
People don't quit the jobs for YouTube until they've got hundreds of thousands of subs.
Not necessarily.
I know, but you.
Few that
it doesn't. A thousand.
There've been a few, but
he just refuses to get that job.
Yeah.
How much money do you think you're gonna make though? I mean, even with 10,000 subs, you don't make anything.
But that also depends on how much we push stuff, too, though.
Yeah.
I think.
And I actually do have a friend of mine named Adam. He's actually, like I said, he's coming over here in September from overseas. But, like, he is in marketing and business type stuff. So, like, he knows how to market things. And if we can get him to the videos, who knows how much we can make.
Yeah, but
that's what I'm saying. We've literally got a whole team ready to fucking
go. Yeah, he's never talked about this guy before. I don't think he's talked to him since.
No. Oh, can I just see me in there? Because as asked, did he ever admit that he's crap at music? Never. No. He thinks he's brilliant at all his endeavors.
Yeah,
And an asshole too. Like, he never wants to put any work into him.
Do you think Cyrex would rather get a job or cut his right arm off?
Cut his right arm off.
I guess he could still race with one arm, yeah.
He could maybe still paint. I don't know. I mean, the painting thing, the art, he either traces a picture and he says it's a tattoo technique, or he, I mean, did everybody see that picture that he painted me? It was that sludge. Well, I've got his bottle of sludge and threw it on the canvas. It was disgusting.
The cityscape?
Yeah, I thought it was terrible. I mean, he drew in a dark pen on the actual canvas and then just let it leak everywhere because he put what? He was using oil paints with water, the idiot.
You know that you and I had an actual disagreement about the quality of that painting.
We did, yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty good. You know, art's subjective, I guess, but I...
Were you on about the one on his website or the one that he painted me?
I thought the one he painted me was the cityscape.
Yeah, there's two. There's one that's on his website that he's stolen from somewhere. Smudge the picture, and that's quite good. And then there's one that he actually painted for me live on a stream, and it was just this tiny canvas, and it was just all brown because he just let everything run.
Yeah, I remember that. He was drawing like little squares in the middle of it.
Yeah, and trying to make it. And he just got it wrong.
That was terrible.
I think you've seen the wrong one, Marty. I really do. I don't believe that you think that was good. I just don't.
The one with like the cityscape, it had like the yellow rooms, and then there's blue. There's like dark blue.
Yeah, that's right. But you've looked at the one on the website. Then the one that he did that he painted on the stream was just brown because it all ran into one another.
Yeah, it looked like something a kid drew. It was literally it looked like something like a kid drew, like a fucking third grader.
Yeah, I did start questioning like your taste when you said that you thought that was good.
Well, apparently I'm the only one. Carrie's saying that it looked like a 5-year-old drew it.
Yeah, okay. I agree.
Yeah. Oh, I've got to tell Carrie something.
Oh, this is a different Carrie, but yes, absolutely. Oh, yes. Oh, please do. Yeah.
Someone sent Cyrax an art set and he thinks it's from me, and I'm so sorry, I never corrected it. I just let him think that I'd actually sent him something. I'm sorry, whoever it was. But yeah.
And I remember when Schmeckle asked me, like, so why does Cyrax think that Tan sent the art set? And like, it took me, I wasn't sure what to say or think. And I remember saying, well, I'll tell you why. Because Carrie's a dirty liar.
Trying to take credit for my upset. How are they?
Carrie and Reckington are such nice people.
Yeah. I know.
It was funny at the time, though.
Yeah.
It was.
How can I say?
No, right. No, of course. I it wasn't taken to heart by anybody, so I mean, so it's all good. It's just fucking funny the way it came out.
Yeah, I mean, really put me on the spot.
Yeah, I was unaware of things, at that time.
Oh, yeah.
I was unaware of things at that time.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Sorry. No need.
No, I'm... Something else I was thinking about too, and I said I'm not trying to, say, anything, bad going or anything, but this is just something that I've kind of learned over time. For me, like, especially, there is no plan B. Is with a plan B that makes you feel like, oh, it's okay.
Yeah, he was just watching his Arnold Schwarzenegger video again.
Yeah.
You don't make it. Like, if you want to do something, you need to make it.
Apparently, RuPaul and Connie didn't believe in the plan B either.
Go out and do something. Make what you want to do happen. And that's why I'm going so hard. I know.
Oh, dear.
I know for a fact that if we do this properly, we won't have to worry about shit. There is no plan B for me. Like, this is it. It's sink or swim.
Well, I don't think, look, my opinion is that for something like this, it should be something that you do in tandem with having a real life. And I think that's what, if you had a real life.
That's the thing, though. This is my real life. This is my real life.
Oh, dear.
I was getting really mad at this point.
It's not gonna, how do you know? You don't know it's gonna work, though. You can't guarantee it. You're
yes, I do know. I do know it's gonna work because how? I have the guts, I have the determination to make it happen. That's the thing. Like, and a lot of people think that I'm delusional. I think the most successful people in the world got to where they're at.
Well,
they didn't send me on some, no, they didn't send me on some fucking office.
Yes, they did.
But most of them, yes.
Yeah.
Questions. Rent Free Home said, I have a good question. What is Tang going to do with their new found free time?
That's a good question.
Yeah, I mean, I would guess that, like, and I can't speak with Tang, but I think that we're, you know, obviously everyone here is very enthusiastic about Cyrax. I don't think any of us could quit him. But yeah, it's a good question.
It's taken a lot of my time up, and I'm fortunate enough to be able to, I could dedicate the time to it. But I need a break. This call that shows I'm getting frustrated. I just need a break and to just enjoy being able to come on stream, have a laugh. Because that's been something that's, you know, been quite frustrating, not being able to join in anything.
Yeah, because, you're doing, like, pretty much all the work here, you know.
Most of the streams that you've had lately, guys, I've kind of produced, so...
Oh, without a doubt, like, you know, she would encourage Cyrax to, you know, you're letting him walk all over you. You got to go and confront him. Like, you're embarrassing the both of us.
Do you think he's going to lose his backbone a bit now?
There's certain aspects to, I think when he finds out certain things, I think he's going to do
it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, man, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah, now Tange can finally get to her 500-piece jigsaw puzzle she's been sitting on for, like, 3 months. Finally get to it.
Yeah, I'm not a jigsaw puzzle type of person.
Up on some Netflix.
I'll do some... Oh, Sally wanted me to do some crocheting with her, so maybe I'll...
We're going to make Chance some booties. Yeah. I'm make him a new knit cap to cover his scabs up. He's wearing the other one out. The oils in his head are eating through it.
Yeah, Crazy Schizo said you could just say you were lying to Marty to get info from him, like Caitlin did.
Double cross.
If you ever want to go back to it? Yeah.
Yeah, like a double cross.
Yeah.
I'm undercover. I'm a double agent.
Well, I guess I'll have to be very careful.
Maybe building a case up for the FBI.
There's enough FBI people in this stream without me being one.
Yeah, Tange, are you excited for him to do a 180 and hurl awful, disgusting insults at you?
Yeah, can't wait.
Why don't you take your $2 tits and stick them up your $2 ass?
Why don't you go tell Bubba about Bertha being a bitch and all that jazz? Maybe you should tell... I love when he gets into his
head. Why don't you make like a tangerine and peel out of here?
I am looking forward to him getting really mad at me, you know, raging. Can't wait.
I always love to see him fired up. He said 20's at his best.
I feel like that I'm going to take over Marty as his arch enemy. I think that I'm going to be on top.
Well, I think he may just lump us together, but I mean, I'll say this, that Tangerine is the 2021 troll of the year. There's nothing that can happen.
Pretty good.
From here on out that would take that away, I don't think.
Oh, thank you.
Well, I mean, it's true. I mean, like, look, you know, everything he's done, he's been Tangerine's puppet.
It's been a pretty good year.
Yeah.
Like, you have Hitler saluted.
Yeah, you have no idea how much of a string that Tangerine has had over his psyche.
Oh, man.
Like, he's not a hateful guy as far as, like, racism or anti-Semitism goes. But, you know, it's put into his head that it would really hurt me. Not that I was delighting in every moment of it. yeah, it was definitely placed into his head. And, you know, you got to ask yourself, where do you think those ideas come from?
Yeah, I mean, I know a lot of you guys actually thought that I was a deranged person for being interested in him. And I must have done such a good job that people believed that it was actually happening.
Oh, yeah.
I've had a number of people message me and ask me, is this for Tangerine real? Yeah, I guess, as far as I know, I mean, how the fuck am I supposed to know? I'm in the same boat you are, you know? I don't know.
I would always mention the brother thing and be like, well, listen, here's what I think it is, you know?
I've brought that up once or twice as well.
Yeah.
You know, the affection, the sympathy, the, what's it called? When it reminds them of somebody, not the recollection, but like the resemblance. There you go. Yeah.
Sometimes they say that girls actually look for men that are quite like the fathers. Well, in Tangerine's case, I was looking for someone like my tiny teen brother.
Canada asks, did Sarkser figure out your comments on his channel from just a few months ago, calling him a goblin and a freak?
Yeah, Lava Girl, thank you, pointed that out to him. And I just said, oh, look, I was just mad and jealous about Caitlin, and he at that time was thinking he was getting a racing rig in the studio, so he just went, all right then, and carried on.
Yeah, it seemed like what enabled Tange to have complete control over him was the promise that he was going to get a toy.
Yeah, that rig in the studio.
Yeah, like that, like especially in the final days was like what really kept him going.
And I rise and I fall and I fall and I fall and I fall and I fall.
In fact, I don't know if I'm remembering this correctly or not. I think maybe we just assumed that he would, but I think we threw at him that maybe he could have this could all stop and get a lawyer, or he could get his big boy racing rig.
Yeah.
What did he say? Cause
he actually agreed, and I was so surprised.
I remember that. Well, wasn't Lava on the thing or something on your other channel? He's like, how could you not get a lawyer? You know, how would you not take the money to get the lawyer to help me? I do remember him saying that.
Yeah, that was another instance. But just recently, he thought he was getting a racing rig. I told him that I'd gone out and got him one anyway. And I said, well, look, I'm going to send it. If you really want to get a lawyer, I'm going to send it back and we'll get a lawyer to sue Marty. And he went, yeah, he agreed to it. I was really shocked at that.
Yeah, at that point, he probably really wanted to. I mean, this guy really wanted to fucking get Marty at that point to give that rig up.
Okay. I see two comments here. One, wait, so who is Lava Girl to Tange? Because Lava was a part of this too. Maybe throw some credit her way too. And then Lava Girl says, Tange, you gave me such a hard time. Like, I was privy to these exchanges, and it seemed like Wobble was just trying to take Cyrax away from Tange at times.
I felt, Lava, I'll tell you this, it was just, in my mind, Tange is a character, and you came along and we were just playing, we were acting, you know, I don't know you personally, you don't know me, and, you know, I will get over it.
Good. I'm glad
you gotta play the role, you know, you gotta play the role.
So. Yeah. And I kind of thought you got that as well a bit, Lava. I think you knew that, you know.
Quite a few people didn't catch on, it seems, Tange. Quite a few people didn't catch on.
Yeah, Gina Windstar, you know, for one, you know, all respect to her, but she was like, she was just more caught up in it, I think, than anybody.
Yeah. He was disgusted with me, you know, and I was actually being called a rape sympathizer at one point, not by Gina, but in Cyrax's side chat.
Yeah, I mean, like, you got, well, I mean, I don't maybe the people who were that committed to it might even just double down and be like, I know this is just a ruse.
Yeah. I do believe I did see someone call you Tanger Rape Cat at one point.
God. It's been, I've had some baptisms of fire with certain things. And I've enjoyed every minute of it. Sometimes poor Marty. You've had me moaning on several occasions, haven't you? Going off.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. I think Picturegate was the worst. And, you know, like, I'm sure this takes a toll on you having to be there for every Cyrax moment, you know, and just have, because he's relentless, you know, like he probably just won't leave you alone.
Right, well, probably runs to you at every little turn or, you know, problem.
I had, when I needed time, I had Martina go and talk to him. He had his little side chicks, didn't he?
Yeah. I wonder if he'll continue to be as trusting or if he just doesn't care.
Well, now I think that he's a single man, I think he's just going to go crazy in the Discord and just start fucking just sending pics out, man. You go on the dick pic spree and just fucking let them all loose.
I've got to say, Lava Girl, yeah, you did play your part. It was really quite interesting to have that little twist, because it did make us think, didn't it, Marty? It made us...
I'll tell you, Lava, honestly.
I mean, if she's being sincere about it.
Well, no, truly. Like for there was a moment where we were convinced that it was over. Like, it was definitely, like, Tange was positive. There's no way we can win Cyrax back.
I was absolutely bummed out. But
Yeah. There had to be, like, a real rally the troops moment.
Yep. Yeah.
You know, because Cyrax, like, at that point, after he blocked Tange, I think one of the first or second times, like, it was, it was tough. I don't even remember what she found or what it was, but I knew that the key to getting around that was John Souter, the fact that the attorney she said she contacted hadn't heard from her, and that if we just stuck to that,
right?
You know, that she's the troll, and you know, I knew that John R. Souter was our key, and that it was salvageable.
Hook, line, and sinker.
I mean, if you think about it, he came on the stream screaming at me, and like all for Lava, and then he told Lava that she was a bitch, and yeah. To me, he was back and forth. He didn't know which way to turn. But I'm glad now, Lava, that it's all out. We can get to know each other properly now.
Yeah.
You know, hopefully no hard feelings. It was just the game.
Yeah, and you definitely you definitely gave us a very good challenge, too. You know, to be honest, I thought it was done, but I figured, you know, I would at least try to convince Tanj that there was a glimmer of hope, but I didn't know. I thought it was dubious, but we had to believe and we had to stick to John R. Souter. And with that, you know, good game, Lava. You definitely gave us a run for our money.
After this incident, do you think Cyrex will trust another cat?
No.
He already hates Schmeckle, and now Tangerine. Maybe someone will come in like Banana Bear.
If you see Ginger Cat, he'll piss himself like Tiny Tim did with the dogs.
Oh, man.
Todd asks, did the police actually show up at Cyrus's house?
Yeah, they were pissed off that they had to go again because they're there all the time. People call them all the time. They just took one look at him, saw that he didn't have any blood on his face at that time, went, right, everyone's all right, and then went. So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure, like, the impression that I get is that he probably strikes her off and she doesn't comply, and they just feel it's a waste of their time.
Yeah. Do you think that Cyrex would be interested in a love interest from someone named Kumquat Kitty? Not fall for it.
Kumquat.
I remember during that call, or one of the calls when they were talking about the domestic violence shit, she's like, yeah, well, you know, I didn't, you know, she's like, Bill called them, you know, and they had to take them. Like, she seemed like she didn't even want the police involved or nothing, you know, when she was choked, talking about her getting choked out.
But now you'd like an apology for blocking some control accounts from Lava.
Say that again.
He well, but only
talking to Lava Girl.
Yeah, for blocking 17 of his troll accounts.
Well, that's the magic number, right? Power of the 17.
Yeah, I guess so.
Gina said, I think part of why I was so baffled and disgusted is because years ago, I lived next door to a couple. He was a drunk. He beat her on the regular. And then, but she made excuses. Well,
I don't understand that.
No, I don't either. Why would you continue to? Yeah, you see that often too. It's love, you know. Loves me. No, he doesn't. He's beating the shit out of you. Open your fucking eyes. Oh, I'm sorry. They're blackened and swollen up. You can't.
So Schmeckle didn't even leave the knife. No, of course not. Of course
not. We're not about that bullshit at Bloodshot Records.
No, yeah. that would be illegal.
That would be.
Yeah, I got it out of the kitchen. I just found the shittiest knife and got it out of the kitchen door and put it on.
Yeah, if I left it at Tangerine's door, it would be in the door, not in front of it.
Mm.
Yeah, like when you open it up, it would be in the door.
Oh, right, okay.
That's not a threat. That's a promise.
Yeah. I mean, and just because this is over, assuming that Cyrax, like, it's, and who even knows if he'll listen to this and be like, no. Oh, Marty just brainwashed her, and you know.
Well, I know he doesn't seem to have any real friends, but he certainly does bring other people.
He's saying what?
I said Cyrax doesn't seem to have any real friends, but he does seem to bring other people together. We're all, you know, have friends and now and.
Yeah, yeah, I would agree with that.
Kumbaya, my
lord. Yeah. Kumbaya. Yeah, his real height apparently is 5'3". However, I do not believe that.
I really wish I could have got that tangerine, Jesus, that tape measure stream. You could have got him to done that tape measure stream where he measured himself. That would have been great.
I've been thinking about actually going to visit him in the near future, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I've toyed with the thought, man. I've toyed with it. How far out are you from him, Marty? I'm 4 hours.
I think like maybe like 7.
Oh, really? Damn.
I know, but someone will get arrested.
No, that's the thing, though. I mean, I have played with that thought, and I always think that he would call the cops. But then again, I just, yeah, like, would he even recognize either one of us at first, Marty? I mean, he's probably seen more of me than you, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Like, as soon as you opened your mouth, though. Greetings. He's like, Mom! Code Red! He's here! I think Sally would invite you, you know, if you're polite, you know, Marty, if you're polite, you know, hold a nice demeanor. I think Chance would freak out, but I think you could, you know, get your foot in the door with Sally or Ed.
Well, after this, I think she tried to run me over.
Chance, where are my car keys?
The thing that you've made bomb threats?
Never happened.
No.
I don't know why. In Cyrax, I was looking under the car every day, checking it. I can imagine him with a mirror on the stick.
Chance, go start my car for me.
Yeah.
I don't think I wouldn't trust him. Like the little motherfucker would like just pretending like be zipping around, throw it in reverse or something, and crash through the goddamn garage or something. I don't know if I trust him behind the wheel. Maybe.
I really would love just to
see me in a
place. Yeah,
to get him like around the block just one time in the car.
That wouldn't be enough.
This time, Marty, I'm coming to your house. Do you think he could make it to Marty, boys? You guys think he could make it to Marty without fucking wrecking?
I think
no shot.
He'd have to take like the side streets and shit, though. It'd probably take him like a day to get there because he's got to take the side streets and shit. You can't take the interstate.
Well, he doesn't have a phone, so he'd have no GPS.
Oh man, that's a good point. Unless his mom's got one in the car or something in the truck. Yeah, that's a good point.
I can imagine him like accosting a trike off a child, and because he's so small.
And we all know. Yeah, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Tangerine.
I just could imagine him accosting a tricycle off a child and pedaling all the way.
I mean, if he did have access to a car and no phone, you know he's not the type of person to stop and ask for directions. He'd be like, welcome to Rhode Island. I'm coming for you, Marty.
Welcome to Florida. I'm coming. Is that near Marty?
Not really.
No, that's the point. He's going in the wrong direction.
Yeah, I don't see him try, but I think he's actually just scared to drive.
Yeah.
Like Sally pretty much said as such.
Yeah, she did. He's absolutely
petrified. Well, you can barely see over the wheel, let alone see, period. I mean, I would be pretty fearful to drive as well.
See me in here, because I said, does Tanja actually live in the US? Yes, I do.
Yeah, that part is true.
Does. All fucking day.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Every single person that has ever fought for what they want, they didn't just sit there behind some fucking desk doing a job they hate. No, they went out, they busted their asses, and they made what they wanted to do happen, and that's exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah,
I'm busting my ass, and like, don't get me wrong, man, I'm not trying to make you mad. I'm telling you, like, the way that we can do this,
the way the world works,
isn't to have like me behind some miserable ass fucking job that I hate. Because we already know that if I do that job, I'm gonna be miserable as fuck, and I'm not gonna want to do that job because I'm miserable, because I hate it, which will put on a performance in the long run. Well, let me tell you something that one of my teachers told me.
Oh, here you go. Here you go.
Wise words of wisdom.
I think this was the original Cyrex troll, by the way.
This is something that I learned when I was in like 10th grade, when I was in math class. This is actually something that one of my math teachers told me.
Get that blunted dick out of me.
And you don't like and have poor performance at, but you can sit down and do a job that you enjoy and want to work hard at it and want to push at it. It doesn't make no sense to do a job that you're going to hate or enjoy yourself.
What would you do if you didn't have... Right, let me just ask you this then. So, I mean, it's all very well to have those ideals, but say, for instance, your mum said, that's it, I've had enough, you're out.
Hannah makes a great point compared to how happy he is now.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, he talks over Tanja, same he does to Marty. Yep. He just really doesn't.
I picture he'll be having this conversation 10 years down the line with a different woman.
Yeah, definitely.
Caitlin.
To get out, how would you support yourself? You'd have to do a job that you hated.
That's easy, though. That's the thing, though. The way I'm going to be doing it is I'm not going to be spending money. I'm going to be putting that money up. But so that by the time comes, we can get a house.
How would you how do you pay your bills? How do you pay your rent? Do you know what I mean? I'm not saying don't have the dream.
See, that's the thing. You're not seeing the bigger picture. You're not seeing past what.
Oh, yeah, and I'm sure there'll be some people like who question our ethics, that's whatever, but we did make sure that as things were cranking up that Sally had the guns locked away.
Correct. Yeah. So that's definitely a plus. No access to any firearms. So that's for his safety as well, so I mean.
Yeah, so basically you could argue that we've saved his life.
Anything we did was a free will, so.
Yeah, true.
And that's the thing, you need to start looking past that. Because all the best people in the world, they don't think like everyone else. They don't think like, oh, well, how am I going to pay, you know, this and this. Like, no, they have a goal. They go for it. They have, from a plain example, this is actually something that even I had watched a few times over, actually, is with Arnold Schwarzenegger. He was born in Austria. And people were telling him, oh, you have to have a regular job. You have to do this, you have to do that. And he knew that's not what he wanted for himself. He knew that he wanted better for himself. So you know what he did?
He curled a bunch of CD books.
Sat there and busted his ass. He couldn't wait to do another rep. He couldn't wait to, you know, do those extra push-ups. He couldn't wait to you know, get in the gym and bust his ass. Look where that got him.
He's like, yeah, but how long do you flog a dead horse? Well, the definition of madness is doing the same thing and not
getting... I mean, you know what? Sometimes that madness can turn out results. So what I'm doing, what I'm really doing isn't madness. We are...
It's insanity. It's what it is.
15 years.
Results are already there. Foundation's there. Well, it's just up to us to build upon that. We got the stuff. It's right there. We just got to build upon it and make it happen. That's all we got to do is make it happen. We're right there. We just got to make it happen.
We're right there.
Yeah.
Really quick, did you ever talk to RuPaul?
Let me think about this. I know what you're saying.
I don't think so.
Yeah, I didn't either. Someone asked me a question, and I just said she didn't. I just wanted to confirm. Yeah, I didn't think so.
No.
Yeah, okay. I'm not even going to bother asking the question. It's ridiculous.
So you want to do YouTube full-time and make it not do anything else to make money, but you're convinced about it, yeah?
I'm dead set on this because, and I know you probably know what this feeling is. Like, have you ever had a feeling like, and I'm sure you had this feeling with the job that you're doing now. Have you ever, like, you were that gut feeling that you have, like, that you know, like, this is what you want to do? Like, you know that this is the kind of thing that you're meant for.
God, where does he get this shit from?
Hmm?
Are these mother, you know that he's just watching day in, day out, motivational speaking shit.
Yeah, I mean, I agree it's bullshit, but I get the vibe that you really don't think much of motivational speakers.
No, it's funny for old rope. It's clever. They just go around talking shit. People lap it up, yeah.
Cyrax just... And that's the thing that is so annoying. You can tell he's just regurgitating shit.
Mm. Yeah, he doesn't understand...
We gotta be all that we can be in the army.
Here's the thing, though. Here's the thing. Your attitude is your altitude.
We gotta fight for our right to party.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Yeah.
Also, I used to... give him a little new phrase every day, and he likes to, if he picks up something, it's like a magpie with phrases. If I said something or a word that he'd not heard before, he'd pick up on it and use it in his stream.
No, we've noticed that with the word narcissist.
Oh, well, I didn't give him that one, but someone must have done. What's a narcissist? Marty is.
Yeah,
that's the definition.
Can you define it without using Marty?
No.
Yeah. You gotta love him. He's the best.
All right, guys. I'm going to get off the stream and go watch the telly with my family. It's tea time.
Yeah. I was amazed at how he scoffed at Sally about the wrestling. I don't give a fuck.
And he had an ice cream sandwich. Do you want an ice cream sandwich?
He just let it melt. He didn't eat it.
He just sat it with it, he's melting.
Maybe that's how he likes it.
Yeah, the rat will have a little...
It's not so, like, harsh on his teeth.
Oh, yeah.
I bet, like, when he eats really cold stuff, they're sensitive, or, like, sugar, but his teeth just fucking scream at him. Let me out!
I mean, I can imagine him just letting it melt in a bowl, and then him just, like, lapping it up.
Like the dog going for it.
Yeah.
And then he gets to it before.
Sorry.
Well, he's too upset for ice cream. Yeah, as Sally said, that when he's upset, he just doesn't really eat.
No.
But he shouldn't have accepted it then. He should have just told her to leave it in the freezer.
Well, I always imagine him just throwing dinner down and the dog fighting. Whatever's put down. That's probably my head. They got a knickers in a twist about it all. Because she had to join in as well.
Benelli's asked for Wenger's calls. I don't think he's picking up tonight. We could have tried, but.
Yeah, he wasn't picking up. I was thinking about doing something on stream, but I may just save it for off stream. But we can give him a try. We can jingle him again. Give him another jingle.
Yeah, I don't even think he's going to pick it up. Like,
I don't either. Yeah. I don't either. Yeah,
I'm not even going to say this. Skip it.
I know for a fact that, you know, I can do this.
Well, let me tell you my opinion on it then.
Call him from a different number.
Being able to do something and make money out of it and do something that you're truly passionate about is amazing. That is such a good thing. On the flip side of it, if you you know, you've got to live, and I do a job that makes me a lot of money, and I do it because, not because I love it, I mean, I do get a thrill out of making money, but there's reason you get satisfaction. I absolutely, but it's for the money as well. That's the main thing, the money, because I want to have a life that job affords me. But if it didn't make money, I wouldn't do it.
That's the thing.
Did we not try and give him a job that doing what he loves and setting him up with that when we posted those links on Pornhub? Posted the videos on Pornhub and shit. Weren't we not just trying to set him up with something he was, you know, loves to do for a career?
Exactly, Zoe. He's like, he whacks off like a little monkey.
I don't know why he just doesn't get verified on Chatterbait and just go crazy, clean up.
Yeah.
I've been trying to get Michelle on Chatterbait. First call-in show on Chatterbait ever. We're gonna make it happen.
What about OnlyFans? I don't know really what. I know it's.
I think that's just pictures. You can do videos, but you pay a monthly subscription. OnlyFans, Snapchat Premium, I believe they're the same thing. You pay a monthly subscription to somebody to see pictures and videos. Whether they're scantily clad or whatever, that's what it is.
A scantily clad
sire. Naked, yeah.
And I guess I probably should apologize, like, to everyone's sleep schedules here. Literally everybody.
And that's right there. That's what separates me and you apart from everyone else. Because, like I said, we got that. As a matter of fact, I was looking at my SoCal this morning. It's literally, since the shrine.
He set the record. Nobody has ever gotten 1,000 subs in 2.5 months.
Never.
Especially if the pitch is
I've seen it happen in one day, to be honest. I mean, that's just because someone's coming over from a different platform and, you know, there's like, all right, I'm starting up a YouTube, and, you know, all the people follow them from one platform to another. I mean,
well,
but Cyrex, you know,
it has literally stood still. 1,195. It has stood still there. It has not budged an inch. It is there solid. It's that right there. It's like, it's kind of like building a house. You know, you can't build a house, you know, just, you know, having this and this. No, you have to have a foundation laid down and, you know, build upon that foundation, have the walls put up and everything.
I think you've watched too many motivational speakers. to tell you all this stuff.
Well, you know, also at the same time, though, look where a lot of that motivational talk got me. It got me to 1,000 subs. And if it can get me to 1,000 subs, where else can it get me?
Well, I mean, yeah, actually, I'm not saying don't try. I definitely think you should try, and I definitely think that you should, you know, pursue this, but I'm just saying it doesn't have to be all of your life, all of your time, because that's...
There's like a echo. Sorry.
I'm not saying like, right. You know, like, obviously, you know, I'm gonna wanna, you know, obviously take days off, but the one thing I did learn especially coming up, like, even though, you know, I'm not in the music scene anymore, you know, one thing that I did learn from Frank Coda when he was still around was that if you're going to do something and, like, you really want to make something work, like, you wanted to do it with his music and stuff, like, you got to be willing to give it at 110%. You don't settle for anything less but the best. And that's what I'm doing now.
He does all the songs in one take. So.
Just like, I know for a fact that, like, obviously I'm not going to be doing it all day long, every day. Like, no, I'm not.
Oh, is that a steel joke?
You know? Like, I'm going to do my thing and then pop off and, you know, do whatever.
Yeah, so even if his job was, say, racing, which I think it was at the time, he would still only want to do it like 2 hours a day and then draw or sing or whatever.
Yeah, he did say that to me when he decided that he was going to be a writer. He wanted to look for a publisher. He decided that all he'd need to do once he'd produced this book, however he was going to produce it, he'd just need to go to book signings and the occasional art gallery for his paintings, and this I could get up late, swan about while I went to work. So just then, I'm trying to make the point to him, look, you know, you can do YouTube, but it's going to be in tandem with a real job. But he thought, oh no, what I meant was, he thought I meant, you know, his spare time, you know, the time with his family. So he's still, the fact of getting a job just goes over his skull.
Yeah, I don't think he would ever or has ever really considered it.
No. Or will ever.
And he admits that if even if he did get a job, he wouldn't be able to cope with someone telling him what to do.
Yeah, for sure. Marty, you got to get his autoerotic asphyxiation videos. He does autoerotic. I don't think he has yet.
I didn't mean that. I mean,
when I do it, I'm going to give it everything I fucking got. To push as hard as I can, because I know that deep down, like, I know that, you know, I can do this. So like I told you this morning, give me the tools, I'll show you the results of what I can do. I'll show you what I'm capable of. Getting those tools to make that happen.
Exactly, and that's how.
Yeah, buy me a big boy steering wheel. That's what I hear.
How people do it, that's how, like, actors who were out, like, these big stars, when they were, when they were going forward with things and trying to make it happen, they had jobs to support themselves while they made it happen.
Well, not necessarily. There's a few actors that actually didn't have anything. Like,
oh, this is so great. This is the best.
Oh, yeah, I remember this.
Yeah, this is so great.
Daniel Radcliffe.
Oh man, I was gonna lose my shit at that.
Yeah.
Daniel Radcliffe didn't have anything when he was started. He started at 11, you dickhead.
Yeah. Like, I mean, this isn't like 1910. He's not gonna be like a chimney sweep.
A mobster.
Yeah. Harry Potter, is that Harry Potter?
Daniel Radcliffe, yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, just unbelievable. Just fucking unbelievable, this guy. But yeah, I remember hearing this moment. I was like, Cyrax, like, dude, you're 31, and, like, you know, he was a kid.
That's the thing, though. He didn't have anything.
Shirley Temple.
Yeah. Well, I don't think he had any bills, because, like, most 11-year-olds don't.
Yeah.
No, his parents were looking after him. He was 11.
Classic.
That's fucking great. I'd love to hear his response.
Yeah, but here's the thing, though.
Honestly.
But still, point being, though, he had literally nothing. There's even a few actors that, you know, even adult actors that, you know, didn't really have anything at all. And they busted their ass to about it.
Where do you think they got money from?
Looking at it every day. Go at it.
Where do you think they got to live and eat and everything from?
But that's the thing, though. A lot of these adult actors that, you know, they weren't, you know, some of them weren't working.
Exactly.
Some of them weren't doing anything. They were literally going in every day, day after day after day, doing call after call after call.
But how did they support themselves? I'm only asking out of, you know, curiosity. How did, if they didn't have any money and they weren't working and they were trying to get to that point where they made it, they must have had, like, a job to support themselves.
Yeah, but also at the same time, though, you got to figure, too, though, the stuff that they were doing.
This is unbelievable.
I watched a documentary on it the other day.
Yeah, yeah, just... He is incapable of considering reality, even for a moment.
That's the thing, though.
But here's, yeah, here's what you're not getting, though. Daniel Radcliffe had his parents, just like I have Sally.
Yeah, Daniel Radcliffe only started with a toy car and a teddy bear. Look at him now.
And I'm going to have a big boy wheel, so imagine what I can do with that.
Yeah.
He's just so sick.
I forget who it was, but they had brought up this one actor that just could not stand his job. Like, couldn't stand it for nothing. Like, he hated it, and he knew that... You know, he didn't want that. He knew he wanted more for himself. So what did he do? He basically took the money that he had. And he was just like, you know what? Screw this job. Well, I'm done.
Sure, but Cyrus, how much money do you have?
Yeah, you should do the same.
Yeah. How much money do you have?
I'm going to put my work, my, you know, my efforts... into a job that I enjoy. And, you know, he kept calling each week for call-ins and callbacks and stuff like that. So he finally, you know, got a response and they allowed him to come in. And it wasn't until like 4 or 5 callbacks later that they actually brought him on. They were, hey, you know, like what you got, go ahead and come on back. And from there, dude went up. Hell, Machine Gun Kelly, who's a music artist, was homeless. Homeless as shit in Cleveland, Ohio. Did not have a penny to his name.
Yeah, but he has talent.
Correct.
And work ethic, I would say. And charm. And, you know, things that you are completely lacking.
Do you know what he did? You and his friends gathered up as much money.
Oh, yeah, and he also has another thing you don't. Friends.
No. Oh, they're all dead.
No, true. True. It's funny. Like, just when somebody dies and they can't really rebut Sarek's claims is when he drops them. Just pathetic.
Yeah.
From, you know, people that they could, and they took their chances. They went out to some sort of competition or whatever, knowing that he could lose, knowing that he didn't stand a chance in hell at making it.
I know, but he'd not been trying for 11 years before that.
Actually, he kind of was.
He's not old enough, but look.
Yeah, he actually was trying. Like, he was literally.
Well, yeah, so I guess, you know, he was born in 1990. I guess like he had a record deal when he was 20. Cyrax is 31.
Well, if you listen to him, he was going on about actors and adult actors. In his mind, he still thinks he's 70.
Huh. 31.
He's stunted at that age. Not just emotionally, I mean, if you look at how he depends on it, every time he's got to make a decision, he ran to Sally. So we're two adults having a conversation.
Yeah.
An adult relationship. And he ran to Sally. It was embarrassing.
Yeah, I can only imagine.
I mean, well, yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm looking, like, when he was 19, Machine Gun Kelly was awarded, like, Best Live Performer. So he hadn't, like, coiled away for a clock, like, 15 years. I think Cyrus was in music when he was in high school. But, yeah, so even his own points fall completely flat.
Homeless, but he would also go to, like, his friend's house every so often. And, you know, do music sessions and this, that, and the other. And, like, he knew that that's what he wanted to do. And ultimately, though, look where he got. And here's one thing on it. If they can do that, and all these other people can do what they want to do, what's stopping me? What's holding me back?
Well, I think what's holding you back, you need to sort your health out first. I think there's, like I told you last night, you know, there's more pressing issues at the moment. You need to, you know, I want you to be healthy and I want you to be in a position where you're not raging.
As a matter of fact, that's something that me and Mom were speaking about too, is, you know, getting myself under control and things that I need to do to, you know, get a better mindset. And I definitely do want to do that. Like, you know,
so,
I do want to get back to, you know, like the you that you knew before, or like outside of all this craziness when it started going off. Like, I do want to get back to that good point where, you know, I wasn't flipping out, where I wasn't, you know.
All right, let me ask you this then. So, I've said, yeah, I'll get equipment for you, I'll get you the tools you need. It's expensive though, so you need to get it insured. Where are you going to get the money for the insurance every month?
That I'm not sure. What I'm going to do is I am going to try to talk to Mom to see if there's like some way.
Yeah, there you go.
Like I can work out a deal with them where I can do, you know, like washing the car, yard work.
What child?
Said he should be doing to begin with.
Yeah, Shelly's like 70.
Exactly. But I've got a bit of an anecdote for that regarding the money and Sally. When we were arranging for me to go down to Akron, I asked him what we're gonna do, what's the itinerary. So I said, well, what's an itinerary? What the fuck? A plan, what are we gonna do? And
couldn't Google it either.
Say that again.
Like he couldn't have Googled it?
No, well, no, he just didn't know.
You couldn't spell itinerary, Marty.
True.
I was speaking to him. I mean, well.
Okay.
So I said, right, where are we going to go? What restaurant are we going to go to? Where are we going to eat? And he presented me with some choices that I weren't impressed with, really. But he said, in the end, you can choose. You choose.
So, yeah, I think they like this place serves. It's like a sit-down restaurant. It's not like McDonald's or anything like that. But I think they serve like a $2.50 cheeseburger.
Oh, wow. You mean like two of them?
Yeah, there is the Chameleon Cafe in Akron or the Dine and Dash.
Dine and Dash. That's very recommended.
I feel that place is just asking for it.
And I mean, I'm not the sort of person that, you know, if I'm with the right person, I don't care where I am, but obviously this was Cyrax, so I said, no, I want to go somewhere nicer than that. And he says, well, you pick. So I went on TripAdvisor and picked, what was it called?
The steakhouse?
Yeah, the steakhouse.
Oh, shit.
I'm trying to think of the name of it.
Oh, fuck. It was like Ken Miller or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Akron restaurant. Let me see.
What do you think? What do you think? Cyrax would wear to like a nice dinner like that, to like the mesh shirt and the knit cap.
I think I wear his finest Auschwitz garb.
What do you think, sir? We have a dress code in here. I got shoes. I got a shirt. I need service.
Yeah, I bet.
Do you think he owns like a suit jacket, Marty? Or like,
no.
What do you think you?
I think. Well, anyway, it's a. I was surprised because the thing that I'd have on the menu, I looked at the menu, and it was $65 plate, the entree.
So we can split it.
I thought it was going to say, oh, no, because I said, well, what sort of place do you want to go to anyway? An economical, something like that. He didn't say that word, something cheap. So anyway, I said, look, this looks decent. What do you think? And he went, great, I won't mind that. So I said, well, are you sure? Because I was just so taken aback. Are you sure about that? Yeah, I've never been to somewhere like this. I'd love to go. So I thought, well, right, okay. Anyway, so excitedly, I went and told Sally that it was, because I knew that he'd got the wrong end of the stick here. I said, Sally, look where he's taking me. So there was this mad rush of Cyrax running downstairs. Sally shouted up to him, what are you doing? And she ran saying, he can't afford that. He can't afford to go do it. Well, it's okay then, we won't go, I'm not bothered. She says, well, what I'll do is I'll get him to do some gardening and I'll give you the money.
Oh, wow.
Bearing in mind we're both in his 30s, I said, no, you won't. That's pathetic.
No. It's like the middle of winter. What type of gardening could you do, you know?
Well, she said that she'd save it for springtime.
Oh.
And that she'd give us the money. So his own mother would have to pay for his first
date. You think she has, like, Sally has a drawer full of IOUs from Chance?
Absolutely.
And you know that he wouldn't do the gardening. Like, he's like, well, bullshit. That money's coming gone. I'm not doing it unless you give me more.
Yeah, no, definitely not.
Yeah.
I got a concert to put on.
But like I say, I don't have an you know, when you're with the right person, it don't matter what you're doing. You could have a party on a park bench, but I just wanted to push him to his, you know, to see what he would accept. So he was willing for me. Well, the next message after Sally had spoken to him, he went, you're paying for it, aren't you? He sent me a message saying, are you paying for it? No, you are.
Oh, yeah, you're going to buy me a fucking racing rig and dinner.
Mm.
And like, you're coming to visit him and stuff. You're using gas money to come travel to him. I mean, Jesus Christ. You're probably, if you get a hotel room, you're paying for that too, of course.
Well, yeah. They were insisting upon a motel.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So that's fairly cheaper. Like, you know, hourly rate.
Sally was very excited that I said to get a hotel, though, because that it meant that they could have the house with us, you know.
Yeah. Me and Ed been wanting to do some weird shit.
Yeah, I'd like to think that Ed would get on Cyrax's microphone and big boy wheel.
just like strap himself in.
Yeah.
Naked.
Yeah, for sure. For
ass print on the chair.
Put on his beanie and clothes and shit. Just in his room.
Like, all right, you guys, this one's coming from Big Ed. You know, he's watching him all this time. Figured he'd make his big move.
It's my time to shine.
Oh, God. He'd be there with just a mesh shirt on and nothing on his bottoms.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Taji asks, can he do basic math at all? No, because he's going to sell 38 CDs for $10 a pop. And I think 15 paintings for, or no, 15 digital art pieces for $20.
Yeah.
And he came out with $8,300 as his proceeds.
Well, digital art pieces alone are only $300. I didn't hear the first thing, but the fucking art pieces are only $300. So, yeah, he's a bit shy.
Yeah, it was $380 for his CDs.
$380?
Yes, yeah. It came to $680, but he got $8,300.
Oh, wow. You definitely messed up the decimal point somewhere in there.
Well, I don't know what he's doing, but I said, how did you get to that? And he went, oh, he's there or thereabouts. I've added it up.
Pretty impressive.
I would tell you that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
on the lawn. I'm doing whatever I can to get the money together.
But instead of doing that yard work to do, get the money off your mum, why don't you, that's what I'm saying, you know, you can go outside to another place of work to do it and get more money. That's all I'm saying. It's a means to a head. Right, I'm not saying that's your life. I'm just
right,
saying.
Like, I know, I'm just saying. Like, you know, I'm just like, you know, coming up with ideas that, you know, I can do for now. Because, like, I know that she's been wanting to help around the house more than this man. And I'm like, maybe I should turn that into something.
Okay.
I mean, your mom wants that's you to so get a job.
You know? That's the thing. Like,
yeah.
You know that she wants you to get a job. Like I said, once we get the tools going, you know, that's going to be my job. How is the monetization go through? Like, once the ban gets lifted on me, I'm not sure if it's Friday or Saturday. I know it's one of those 2 days. But once that gets lifted,
okay.
All you gotta do is wait like another like 1 to 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks at the most.
It's kind of sad that Madness is pinning his career resuscitation on Cyrax's back.
Oh, wow.
Well, yeah, he's like, you know, I'm gonna do a track with Cyrax and I can't kill himself because if he does.
Oh, Jesus. That's what is like his big hope is?
That's what it seems.
Who was that person? I've never come across them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's a juggalo.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, goody.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And then all I gotta do from there is link up my my Cash App, which also ironically is now connecting with my PayPal. Thank you, Cash App.
But
save my life.
How much money do you actually think you'll make with 1,000 subs?
$645.
Yeah.
That was a stressful fucking day with that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Imagine
yeah.
him, like, taking that money. Like, all right, Tans, I'm going to move out of my mom's house. We're going to get a place.
Oh, did you? I had to scream at him to get that money back.
Oh, yeah. And the only thing that got him to do it was the promise of a racing rig.
I'll give you money myself. Just put it back.
Yeah, like, you know, if I can't, if I lose my job, no racing rig.
Bribing him.
That also depends. Like I said, that all depends on the views. Because the way that YouTube works is
I know how it works, yeah.
It all goes by views.
What's your average view count on a video, then? What's your average view count?
I'm not sure. I know that I've got like over so many watches. Yeah, I know that I've got like
Well, look, listen, I've got to go for a bit, but I'm only asking you the hard questions because they need asking. I'm not being defensive. But it's a lot of money for me to put into something right. that where there's no guarantees.
Right. You know, like I said, you know, like I know that this is gonna work out. It's just like I said, we gotta get the right stuff together. Like you told me, it's quality over quantity.
Right.
Now, if we come out. Literally, the best content that we can put out can easily get sponsors looking at us. They can start paying us YouTube.
I get you.
For Super Chat.
Let me tell you this.
Things are going to work out.
All right. Well, let me just say this to you before I go. When at work, what I've got to do is when people want to make investments and I've got to weigh up risks, and by that, what do you how do you know something's going to work? What are the figures? What are the facts? Not the feelings, the facts. So let me know.
Here's the thing, though. Sometimes you can't go on just facts alone. Sometimes you have to take that leap of faith.
You need the basics.
Because here's the thing. Sometimes if you take that leap of faith, not knowing what's going to happen, knowing that you could fail, knowing that you can crash and burn any time, gonna push you even further.
I know, but
this is something that I've learned for the years.
You've gotta keep
people perform better under pressure. If they know that they don't have a safety net and they know that they could potentially crash and burn, they're going to do everything they can to keep that from happening.
It's easy to gamble with other people's money, though.
I'm taking that risk. I'm doing what I need to do to make things work.
Well, just have a look. Like, get as much as you can together to, like, you know, your views.
It's amazing that he believes that someone that works in the financial industry is going to invest in him.
Thousands upon thousands of dollars.
Yeah, $25,000. And he had no concept of actually how much that would take to earn.
What I think helped that along was getting those CDs made for him. That definitely helped that along.
That was a strange going on with Kale. I just didn't get that, what he was trying to do.
It was great to see it backfire in his face.
Well, yes, it was. And I've got to go to prison now for 10 years. Bye.
Yeah, right. I mean, what does Cyrex think when he sees Kale now after hearing that, you know, he had to go to jail? Oh, you beat the case or something? I mean.
Well, yeah, he came back the day after talking to him, trying to convince him not to speak to me. And he didn't even question it.
No, not at all.
Yeah, I guess. You know, I don't think anybody could really beat us, you know. People have tried. No offense to T-Lobby, give us a good run for our money. I guess Rumor Popper had it around. You know, just not happening. And if anyone wants Cyrex now, you can have them. I mean, we'll still cover them. We've got tons of calls. Like, this is just like the tip of the iceberg with the calls.
Oh, man, yeah.
There's about 100.
Yeah. Yeah, like which
for hours. Like you could do a 24-hour stream probably. One haul. If you listen to one haul, I'd be like, ugh, yeah, it's just a lot.
Some are rubbish, you know. There was some trust building, and a couple of the calls I lost, which
tell them
some good ones too, unfortunately. Yeah.
There was trying to get him to admit that Soul Census wasn't his book. Was an interesting task. So I had a quick skip through it. And a lot of the book was based on historical fact. So I started asking him, and he had Attila the Hun and the Mongols in there. And so I asked, you know, how did you research that? And who were they? And he went, they were a biker gang.
A biker gang.
The 1800s.
And oh, wow.
Called the Mongoloids.
Attila the Hun was their leader.
Yeah. So
the Mongoloids
be riding around Agra on these bikes.
Yeah, and you're asking to define words in the book, and he just couldn't even. Oh, like, what was it? He asked him what the census was.
Yeah, what was the census? And he went, well, it's like a feeling. It's.
Like a census is like a group of words that form a thought or a feeling, a statement or a question.
No, that's sentence, motherfucker.
Wait, can Jeff read the book? No, I think we both took a glance at it. I know I didn't really get too into it.
You could just open it anywhere, just look at it anywhere. And
I would only read AJ Vega's book.
Oh, well, and here's the beautiful thing about it. Tanj got the book because I was calling him a liar, you know, and saying that. You know, there's no way this book. So Tanj got the book to prove to me that it was real.
Yeah, and then.
Oh wait, Cyrex's book?
Yeah.
Oh wow, like a physical copy?
No, but like the PDF.
The PDF of it. Oh yeah, that's right. Never mind. I do remember that.
He sent me the second.
Yeah, I did. I don't think I. I don't think I downloaded it.
It's not worth it.
No. I don't think I did.
So it was obtained because Tanj knew that Chance was telling the truth and wanted to prove me wrong.
Yeah, and so I showed him the second book that was secret, saying, look at that, he's written that book, and he'd not. We found that as well.
Yeah, within, like, moments, you know.
It's not hard to find the shit that he steals. Marty, I got your joke earlier when you said he does each song in one take. That's hilarious. Like he steals it one take. That's fucking funny.
Wait, what do you mean?
He said he does each song in one take.
Yeah.
Right, one take. Like he steals it one take. Like I took it.
Clever. Saying, like even his original songs, like he does it one time. He doesn't do multiple.
Yeah, no, he doesn't fix anything up on it.
Yeah, no, that I was just being, you know, straight shooting there.
We know it's going to work, and think about that. But I get what you're saying, you know, there's a calculated risk, though. You wouldn't go take a leap of faith off the Grand Canyon, but you might do over a small river, you know.
And that's the thing, you know, and this is just me saying this, because like I said, like, even though, you know, Rogue Energy obviously did, you know, let me go just for the time being until we can get the stuff going. I can start putting out good videos, which I explained to them in an email. I was like, oh, like, this is what's going on.
Yeah, and Rogue Energy is just something you have to buy and then you have. Yeah.
They wrote back an email, $59.99, please, Mr. Wilkins.
Yeah, or else just kick rocks.
On this one, I'm not able to do anything right now. Like, I'll hit you guys back up when I get the chance. Don't worry. Don't worry. I'm going. But like I said, between the sponsorships that I know for a fact I'll be getting once I start reaching out, between that, and something else you need to think about too is like when I get the monetization going, how do I enable Super Chat? And we already know people are going to want to donate. We already know people are wanting to donate like crazy.
I mean, I know I donated $645 once, but
since it was charged back.
Yeah.
I think I've had nightmares over that.
Oh my God. I felt sick. You know, I really thought that I was going to have a fucking heart attack. As I told you, like, I was like, because he's going to be gloating. He's going to be just on cloud nine, and you know, I'm never going to hear the end of this.
We can laugh about it now, can't we?
But at the time, like, you know, yeah, I was sick. I was fucking steaming. I couldn't believe it.
I liked hearing about it the next day.
I mean, until it was resolved, like, and even only after, you know, like it was for sure that he couldn't get, I was just like, there's, oh my God. But I love when you kind of be like, I've outsmarted you, Marty. I know that you're just trying to sit here. Long prison sentence for fraud.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Yeah, that was definitely an eventful.
I'll have that on top of whatever I'm making from Google AdSense. Between those three things, you put that money in the bank into like a savings account or whatever, and you save that up and you keep that going. That's money that you can live off.
Well, all right then. Have a look into how much someone average, the average earnings of someone with a thousand subs make.
Like, I know that like a lot of the bigger YouTubers
forget them. A thousand subs.
I know so, like, what I'll do is I'll start looking into them and, you know, seeing how much they make.
No, just the small ones. Scale it down, because we want actual figures, not projected. We want actual, what, 1,000 sub channel makes.
Yeah, for sure.
Not a 10,000, not 100,000.
Exactly. But it is good to kind of know that ahead.
Well, it is, yeah, definitely.
That way we know what we're getting ourselves into.
But we need to know.
And see, like, you know, what a starting...
Exactly,
we're right now, and I looked into this earlier today, right now we're considered a basic channel. We're at the base and at a starting point. So what I'll do is I'll look in and see, like, hey, what is a basic, you know, 1 to 2,000 sub, you know, average as far as, you know.
Hey, guys, can I just check my social blade? If everything goes according to plan, I'll make $96 next month on the high end. it can go down as low as $6, but you gotta think that's like 20 cents a day.
we'll live like kings.
Yeah, never have to worry about money again in your life.
Thanks, guys. Yeah.
And I'll look into it and see what I can find for you for sure.
Okay, cool. Well, listen, I've got to go do some of my work then. I think your mum has messaged me. She says, I'll let you work. I'll talk to you a little later today. So will you let her know that I'll call her in a couple of hours?
Yeah, for sure.
And in the meantime, I'm just asking questions. Don't be frightened or anything.
I know I'm not, and I know I kind of came off harsh and I wasn't mean to, but I also kind of wanted to show you this is our chance to escape all this craziness, because I looked into it today, and I found out that I can stream to YouTube without even touching YouTube. What I can do is I can stream the footage to Twitch, and then from Twitch, I can restream it to YouTube to where I wouldn't have to touch YouTube ever again. All I would do is I would set up the stream to YouTube, go from there, and all I have to go to YouTube for, say, like once a month or once a year, however they work it, all I have to do is go there like once a month or whatever. Collect cash.
What is he even talking about?
I don't know. I think I zoned out like I've just zoned out now. I think at the time I just thought, oh my god.
Yeah, but when you're the thing, you get on Twitch and you know, go to YouTube, and YouTube goes to Twitch, and then you're making the big bucks.
Sometimes it bored me that much. I fell asleep on a couple of calls.
Yeah, I think I've heard them.
You just start snoring.
Yeah.
I didn't realize I didn't dare listen to him back in case I just. Well, yeah.
Yeah, and sometimes you just keep talking and talking and talking. It would take like a while for him to even realize that you were just dozed off and.
Snoring like a little piglet.
Yeah. Wow. Does he know what social media is? Because he doesn't even know how many views he gets per stream and stuff. Well, here's the thing that I always found amazing. He'd always tell me that like he gets more views than I do. Which, you know, I don't think is the case. Not that it really matters, but like I was always surprised when he would say that, and like as if it was a matter of fact.
He gets more rope than you do.
That's true. It's kind of like, it's weird that like somebody who covers somebody else gets a significant amount more views than the actual person they're covering.
It's because you make their content interesting.
Yeah, I suppose. But yeah, it's just strange. I think yeah, I got like another 30 seconds here.
Yeah,
I
wonder if I have to record his face ever again.
All right, then. Well, I'm gonna get off, and I understand what you're saying. Like, obviously, think about everything you've said. Take it all into account, and we'll speak later. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're nearing the 3-hour mark here. Mm-hmm. I am getting like a little sleepy. You want to do like another like 15 minutes or so?
I'm ready to finish when you are.
Okay. Would you have any problem teasing people with the like the minute and 20 when he finds out his penis is about to explode?
No, I think we should. Yeah, let's deal with that.
That's okay, a good
let's,
one.
Yeah, let's because that's a quick brief one, but we have so much amazing.
Yeah, I think you could play. Yeah. There's just days.
Yeah, that'll be really good to
do you off. Mean your penis?
I didn't know it sounded like that.
Was it your penis? Yeah.
You're like, wait, what happened?
Oh, the title here might drop off.
Oh, is that what I call you, Mike?
Yeah, I like some of the calls have some colorful titles.
And saw if you remember, they said it was a
day. You've been asking, and I've been asked.
Oh no, I think this is the wrong one here. second here. Let me go up. I don't think it was. It definitely wasn't Special Agent Sally.
No.
That was a good one too. Okay. Yeah, it's the last 130th, I guess, bumming.
yeah, it was bumming. Yeah, bumming. That's anal sex in English.
Oh, yeah, you can see, like, he's gone for a little bit here. But you can hear him, like, rustling around.
Yeah.
I deal with this because it's not on. And I think that it's out of order that he's got away with it. I'm surprised.
Yeah, getting him to, like, go on a live stream and talk, basically admit that he's a rapist. Brilliant. Yeah, well, the thing is, the Me Too movement is getting steam. And, you know, you can ride that bandwagon all the way to the butt.
I love it when you do.
Yeah, it's a lot of money in these rapes. Talking about rape and things.
People love rape.
Yeah. I think here it comes.
Here we go.
Hey, mom's got to run to the hospital real quick. Because literally swelled up like crazy.
And you can notice here, it was just after she was talking about Billy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And the rape, like it sent a little twinge to his penis. It
swelled up like crazy.
Hey, mom's got to run to the hospital real quick. Because it literally swelled up like crazy. It's literally not normal. I don't know what's going on.
What swelled
up? I don't know what's going on. So mom's literally going to run me down there real quick to find out what in the hell is going on.
You've swelled up?
Yeah, literally. Like,
your penis.
What has? What swelled up? What?
You know, I know it's kind of weird, but literally...
What's that?
Oh, yeah. Not normal. So, mom, and down there real quick.
Well, like, you think
you're being
nervous? Yeah, literally, it's legitimately.
Oh, my God.
Play it again.
Yeah. Let's play it again. Let's play it again because, like, it's he's a lot calmer. Than I would be in that situation. And it seemed like it just happened, like, as soon as you started talking about Billy.
Yeah, there's a twinge there, and because we're on about...
Yeah, Billy. Get into the rustling again. 911, what's your emergency? Mom's got to run into the hospital real fast. It's swollen up.
It wouldn't say... He showed it on camera, but he would not say penis. Got it out and it was so unrecognizable.
Oh my God.
It took me, I didn't know what it was. It looked like, I don't know, like a balled up sock. It just.
at this moment, I was a little, I mean, mildly disappointed. I didn't screenshot like the video, but you know.
Oh, I didn't know there was a video. So you saw live Tang when he was like, it's swollen up, and then he just whipped it out on you?
Yeah, but the lighting was so dark, you couldn't tell. You know, unfortunately, my laptop did get hacked and the pictures did come out. So,
yeah. Yeah, this is like the ultimate commercial for a good VPN.
Like, absolutely.
Definitely.
Or a therapist, I'm not sure. There's definitely something to be learned here.
Yeah.
Is it your penis?
Hey, mom's got to run to the hospital real quick. Because literally swelled up like crazy. It's literally not normal. I don't know what's going on.
What swelled up?
I don't know what's going on. So mom's literally going to run me down there real quick to to find out what in the hell is going on.
You've swelled up.
Yeah, literally, like.
What has? What swelled up? What?
You know, I know it's kind of weird, but literally.
What's that?
Not normal. So mom's in her room and down there real quick.
Was that your penis?
Yeah, literally, it's legitimately.
The penis.
Oh my god. Yeah.
No, I'm gonna go down there.
That's your penis.
And I'll claim that as soon as I
Yeah, let me know straight away.
I can't wait to get my PC back. I know what my next project's going to be.
Oh, yeah. His original penis doctor was actually a guy named Dr. Baloney.
Baloney. He went to Dr. Baloney for his baloney pony.
But he didn't actually see him. Like, he didn't take it nearly as seriously as he should have.
Do you think he just threw some cream at him and sent him home? Do you think he not even examined it? Like, he just, like, said, okay, just take this and, you know...
Well, when his GP saw it, you know, like how they're not supposed to react? Well, you know, he actually did. He apparently went, oh, what the... Oh, because in terms of them not supposed to, you know, react, he wanted to go, what the fuck is that? What have you done with it?
Cancel all my appointments. Clear my appointments.
They got him into a urologist quickly at the hospital.
They need to get him into some fucking medical book is what they need to get him into.
Well, he told me that he'd had it before, an infection before, and it's split up like an athlete's foot sort of injury where the skin split and it started bleeding.
Well, you know what's good for an athlete's foot, do you?
Uh-uh. I've never had it.
It's piss.
Huh.
Just like when you know when you get stung by a jellyfish?
Piss?
Yeah, same thing with athlete's foot. So maybe someone pissed on his penis to cure it. Dr. Baloney pissed on his penis. Okay, now I'm just going too far with it. I'm sorry.
You just piss in the bowl? You just piss in the bowl and stand in the bowl?
No, I think he just directly, you know,
he's got shot at him. From the sauce. He can't. Him. Yeah.
Doesn't give much of a target, but, you know.
Yeah, people are asking what the actual fuck. Yes. Yes.
Yikes.
We've got that on a call, I think, as well, when he was describing that.
Yeah, we've got all the penis calls. We've got there's plenty more where that came from as far as these penis calls.
His penis is as far as the eye can see.
Yeah, you're going to learn a lot about penises.
That's a little bit immature calling them penis calls. Can we just maybe call them, like, cock conversations or something?
If you wish.
Or a dick debate.
Maybe dick discussions. Yeah, that'd be good.
Really briefly, and I don't believe this for a second, but I saw that Ricky posted in a Discord that Heather is dead.
I saw someone write RIP too in like comments and shit. I find that very hard to believe.
Me too.
And you know as well as I do, Marty, fake obituaries have been thrown around before.
Yeah.
Many a time.
Agreed.
So until I see a corpse, I'm not buying it. I want to see the body.
What would she die? Well, yeah, that's terrible.
Maybe she, I mean, you know what? I'm really not going to make a joke, like trying to make light of it by any means, 100%. But like, people have died, like by giving birth and shit. Granted, it's like a third kid, but I mean, that is a possibility. I don't know. I'm not speculating, but I can't believe that one.
Not nowadays. It's not 1584.
Okay, fair enough. I don't know. I don't know. I've just heard of it happening. I don't know how recent it's been since it's happened. It's happened like within this current century. What the fuck are you talking about?
It would. Yeah, you're right.
1800s. I didn't say Black Plague. I said that. Yeah.
Well, all right. It's not that common.
Well, we have that. It's COVID, I guess. Yeah.
I'd rather take my chance with COVID than summer.
People are such pussies, man. I'm like, I got a friend. I'm like, he's really good with computers. Man, you come over and help me. He's like, oh man, no, I live with my dad. I can't step outside. I don't step outside of the house. And I don't go in anyone's house unless it's necessary because of COVID. Yeah. Are you fucking kidding me? I hit someone else up. Like, oh, they advertise this thing. Oh yeah, well, due to COVID, we don't have anyone into the house. But if you want to drop it off, I'm like, go fuck yourself, dude. What the fuck is wrong with these people? How do you make money?
I don't know. I think it's pathetic, but.
fuck you. I don't leave the house. I don't go in anyone else's house unless I'm like, dude, I don't. What do you think? I have like people in and out of this motherfucker all day.
Maybe they're professional erasers.
No, they're professional pussies.
Yeah, there's. You can tell some people like once they got these vaccines that they're like braver and like
now they're all cocky and shit. Right, man.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, like if you're old, if you're under 65 or under 50, it's not an issue.
Yeah, I don't even know. I don't even know what. Yeah, they had all the restrictions, like no one could get them, and like now they're saying kids and shit are like dying from it, and it's all. Yeah, I don't know. I have a pretty good immune system. I'm not really worried about it.
It's propaganda and bullshit.
I was like out licking doorknobs in the beginning of the pandemic to boost my immune system. So on you, Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson, I don't need your vaccine. Ha ha ha. Joke's on you. I like Sally's asshole to immune myself from the COVID.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
That's dedication.
Yeah.
Well,
you thought you were dedicated.
I mean, yeah, we've got like 100 calls, like, you know, and I see what we played tonight was honestly probably like a 4 out of 10 of what we got.
Oh, yeah, tip of the iceberg, I mean.
Yeah,
just a little taste.
But definitely stay tuned, and I'm curious to see how Cyrax will respond. I would bet that he's going to say that he was just trolling you the whole time.
Yeah, I knew the plan the whole time. Yeah.
He did actually, Lava. He did send you that, didn't he? That he was undercover trying to troll me.
I don't want to spoil too many of the calls, but like some of my favorite ones are just the simple Cyrus going, "All right, I love you," and then Tanner's going, "Thanks, bye."
Yeah.
Doesn't even say it back. Thank you, bye.
And she's very good at remaining his girlfriend, almost like fiance, but also refusing to accept any penis stuff from
him. Right. I do. Yeah, I applaud you for that. And I remember you saying, I've told him right from the get-go, I don't want any of that shit. I remember you saying that on one of the streams. Yeah, I don't blame you. I mean,
yeah, I've seen it.
Did he try and offer and throw it on you, like, ever? Did he ever, like, try and do anything like that, too, like, with you?
Yeah, he tried to engaging sexual conversation all the time, but I diverted him very well.
Yeah, it was like shut him down.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. What are you wearing, Dan?
Yeah, I would ask him. Once he said, once, can I tell a story about when he offered to? Well,
all right.
Once I was trying to put him off on one particular occasion. I said, look, I don't want to talk about sexual activity. I am currently on my period. Anyway, that's okay. I'll just shove it up your ass.
Oh, man. What's with him in that? Oh, my God.
I don't know.
Jesus Christ.
I didn't know how to reply to that, really. I just...
How about just, like, fucking wait, like, the 4 days, you mongrel?
Yeah, just wait. Let's
get a blowjob. Jesus. What an asshole. I mean, no pun intended on that one, but yeah, what an idiot. Christ.
He's one of the most sexiest romantic things in my
who was it? Megan, he tried to slip it in without without any disregard or permission.
Right, yeah. Down in the dungeon.
Wait, oh man. No wonder she took off so quickly.
Yeah, I love that I'm curious to see how he's gonna respond to this. Hopefully not by hanging himself.
No. Firearms are locked up, thank God.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. It'll be interesting. Only time will tell. I imagine it'll all be when we're sleeping. You know, we'll wake up to a nice, you know, 6 a.m. coffee and chill. But the coffee and chill will turn very quickly to a coffee and drill to start, you know. I fucking knew it all along. Joke's on you guys.
Marty.
You never know what's going to come out of the guy's mouth. That's the best part about him, I think. He just keeps you on your toes. I think that's one of the things I love about him the most. Like, he is predictable, but he isn't. That's what I like about him. And he never quits. It's one of my two favorite qualities. Keeps you on your toes.
It's been a lovely evening.
Yeah. I'm going to stop it here. More to come, Tanj. Thanks.
Thanks for having me, guys. Take care.
I'm sure it feels like a tremendous weight has been lifted off of you.
It's just nice to be able to share.
Yeah, you know, like, she, like, honestly, Tanj's been doing, like, all the work. It would be impossible. None of this would have happened without Tangerine Cat.
Yeah,
like,
very big kudos to you, Tanj. Yes.
You know, people, like, give me credit. This was 100% impossible without Tangerine Cat. 2021 trolled the year, in my opinion.
Agreed. Take care, guys, as well as chat. Have a good night.
See you, Schmickle. Bye.
All right, bye, guys. Oh, wait. Oh, there we go. Wait. Okay. Oh. There we're...